Live from Baton Rouge, North Carolina, Carolina Thunderbirds hockey is on the air tonight. A second game of three here this weekend between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Last night, Carolina falling by a final score of 5-3 in a game that saw only six of the rostered members of Carolina's team play last night due to travel issues. But Carolina last night, they led 3-1 at one point in the first period before Baton Rouge was able to come back and take down the Thunderbirds last night by a score of 5-3. Carolina last night, they only had Gus Ford, Dawson Baker, and John Petita for forwards on the original roster, as well as Sucker Firth and Joe Kennedy with Cody Karpinski, the netminder. And then you saw a huge influx of players coming in for the Thunderbirds, including the likes of Joe Pace Jr., Dominic Matonic, both come from Mississippi, and then people locally here in the Baton Rouge area. Thank you to those who helped out to be able to help fill a roster for Carolina last night. But Carolina, nonetheless, a 5-3 loss last night against the Baton Rouge Zydeco, as the season series is now split at a game apiece. These two sides playing for the second straight Friday. Last Friday, Carolina took down Baton Rouge, picking up their second shutout victory of the season last Friday with an 8-0 home victory back at the Annex. And now Carolina looking to get back on track here tonight with a full roster here this evening with minus Peter Banachik and Josh Keplinger. Keplinger did not make the trip. Neither did Peter Banachik. You'll hear from the head coach Steve Harrison about get a little bit of an update on Peter here in just a little bit. But the past few days have been pretty wild for this Thunderbirds team, but now they are here and they are getting ready to go to battle here this evening at the Raising Cane's River Center. This is the only trip to Baton Rouge here this year for Carolina. These two sides still see each other a few more times back at the Annex following tomorrow, which is an 8 p.m. Eastern puck drop. But now for Carolina, they're looking to bounce back and they are ready to go. They, last night on the bus, they were all watching. They are ready to go. And they're ready to go out and put on a show here this evening. Carolina and Baton Rouge for the third time this season. Carolina comes into today with a record of 28-10-1. Baton Rouge on the other side, 9-25-4. You look at the standings in the Continental Division at the moment. You find Carolina in second place right now. Tonight, their 40th game of the season with 78 points. Baton Rouge on the other side. Tonight, game number 39 for the Zydeco. They have 30 points in 38 meetings here this year. Carolina, they had a three-game win streak snapped last night, and now Baton Rouge, they've won a few here over the past weekend. They picked up a win in Blue Ridge last week, and they picked up the win last night, so they're feeling a little bit more confident as this season's continued to roll along. But for Carolina here tonight, they got to focus on themselves, and they got to
keep up with your vehicles from anywhere. Flo customers can request service appointments, receive text and video updates, view sales and service history, receive recall notifications, and even get purchase offers via Flo Offer to Purchase. Download the app today.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start.
From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score.
So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. With trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday, it's one event too amazing to miss. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
We're back here on Thunderbirds pregame, getting ready for Carolina and Baton Rouge, game 2 of 3 this weekend. Brendan Riley being joined by the head coach, Steve Harrison. And coach, well, we made it down here in Baton Rouge, getting ready to play a game with your full squad here tonight. Before we get into that, last night's game, you had 6 guys come down. They flew down, went through a long day of travel. Joe, Gus, Boots, as well as Tucker and Dawson and Cody, they ended up suiting up for you last night. You know, obviously we're whole team wasn't there, but 6 guys, a lot of help, but a lot of effort exerted by those guys. What do you think of what they had to go through in their performance last night?
Well, I mean, I don't know if everybody realizes what we went through, and I'm not making excuses, and I give those 6 guys a lot of credit. I asked them to go, and they didn't say no, and they jumped on board and came down here and did a heck of a job. And you know, I give them all the credit in the world, and I give the other 12 guys that were sitting at home a lot of credit. They've weathered this storm, and we got down here today, and the bus wouldn't work again, and we've got that going. So you know, those are all excuses, and we're not going to use them. And tonight we're going to put our best foot forward. So I'm excited. I know the guys are a little irritated at what's gone on the last couple of days of what people are saying, but this is going to be our team here tonight, and we're going to go at it hard.
Took down this team 8-0 with your team last week, and you hang around with only 6 of your players last night. Now you go into a game here tonight, you know, guys who didn't play last night have some fresh legs, but now going into game 2 here, what are you expecting from your team?
Well, I expect us to come out the way we've always come out, and you know, it might be a little rusty at the start. Again, the travel that we've had, and again, I'm not making excuses, I'm just explaining how we're going to come out, and we're going to put our best foot forward, but we could be a little rusty at the start, and hopefully we can get a great pregame skate here, as I said, to warm up there and get the guys going. But I believe in this group, and I know that tonight we'll get the results that we want to get, because we're going to work hard.
Now, coming into the rest of these 2 games on the weekend, it's been a good stretch for your team as of late. They've been playing well, then starting to find that footing as now going to the final 18, 19 games of the season. How much importance is put on these next few weeks to make sure that your team's ready to go?
Well, you know, this weekend, I mean, it is a lot of importance. I totally agree with you. And this weekend is here is to get as many points as we can in the next 2 games and get home and regroup. And we're going to do everything in our power to make sure we get 6 points this weekend. And it's going to be tough. They won last night, and they probably feel good about themselves, and they should. They worked hard, and so we're going to have to really work hard. But no, we're as you speak, and we've talked about it the last 2 or 3 weeks on Coach's Show, that this is the time to get this thing going in the right direction. Have we had a speed bump this weekend? No question. But the way these guys respond and the way they feel about each other, I believe that tonight we're going to play a game that people will be proud of and would want to cheer for us.
And we talked about it earlier this week, but Peter Bonacic didn't make the trip down, didn't practice this week, underwent surgery earlier this week. What's the latest on him?
Well, he's out right now, and actually I got to talk to the surgeon and the 2 doctors and Peter and everybody probably on Monday, and we'll see where we're at. I mean, right now he's out indefinitely, probably a couple weeks anyways, or 3 weeks, and we're going to look at it at that time and see if hopefully that I don't know all the details. I'm not a doctor, and until I actually talk to them this week and both doctors, and then get Peter's feeling on it too, and then we'll evaluate it and go from there.
Coach, thank you very much for your time. Best of luck to you here tonight.
Thanks very much.
That's the head coach, Steve Harris. We got more to come on Thunderbirds pregame after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000-square-foot putting green and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
We're back here in Baton Rouge. We're getting ready for Carolina in the Zydeco for the third time this season. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. This game 2 of 3 here this weekend. And obviously, of course, last night, Carolina only with 6 players on the roster, on the normal roster. And that's because of travel issues that the Thunderbirds had. We got to the rink around 9 o'clock, 9:30 there on Wednesday night. Bus was set to leave at about 10:30 when at 9:15 or so, the bus didn't want to start. So Coach Harrison, as well as Kevin, our bus driver, they called and tried to figure out how to do it. So there was a broken patch line on the Thunderbirds bus, and no one was going to be able to get there at night on Wednesday. And so from there, that's when things had to start going to plan B and plan C. Well, plan B for the Thunderbirds was to rent cars at a Greensboro International. And Thunderbirds booked cars through a rental car service. And by the time that about 5 of them got to Greensboro there, and you're looking probably about around midnight there Wednesday night into Thursday morning, it ended up being there was no cars there. And so they came back. And then from there, the Thunderbirds then and the head coach Steve Harrison, Kerry Ross as well, they were on the phone in constant communication. They tried to find a new bus, find a charter bus, and the Thunderbirds ended up being able to, for what they thought, think they secured a bus. Spent money on the bus, and from there expected a bus to come about 4 a.m. So while this is going on, Thunderbirds, the roster, myself, the head coach, all were waiting at the annex. And so we were all waiting for this bus to come, which is expected to come about 4 a.m. Well, about me and 15 of the guys, we ended up going to sleep in the Thunderbirds dressing room. And wake up at about 4 a.m., the head coach Steve Harrison walks in and says, "Not good." From there, the bus never came. The charter bus never came. And at about 7 a.m., 6:45, 7 a.m., Gus Ford walked into the locker room. He said to Boots, Joe Kennedy, Tucker, as well as Dawson and Carps, "Come to coach's office. We're hopping on a flight." So the Thunderbirds got the final 6 seats on a flight from Charlotte that would connect through Atlanta and get them down to New Orleans. So the 6 of them made the trip down to New Orleans, where they were picked up by Joe Cangelosi and Hannah Holland, who made the trip down, as well as John Holland, her husband. They made the trip down on Wednesday to come check out the Raising Cane's River Center, as well as check out Baton Rouge. So they ended up going to pick up the 6 of them, and they made their way here. And that's how they got here to play last night in the game. For the rest of us on the other side, head coach Steve Harrison, myself, and the rest of the 12 players, well, At about 7 a.m., we ended up going home, able to get some sleep in our own beds. Got back to the rink at about 11:30. Bus was being worked on. It was still being operated on. And eventually, at around 1:30, the bus was good enough to run again. And from there, the rest of us, we hopped on the bus, and we got here to Baton Rouge at about 1:30 a.m. last night. Remember that you gain an hour going from Eastern to Central time. So get here at about 1:30 last night. So that means yesterday the rest of the team was on the bus, and we got just past Auburn, Alabama, and that's when last night took place. The game took place last night. Everyone on the bus watching the Baton Rouge stream, watching the whole game, saw what transpired last night, and from there got here at 1:30, and now ready to go here tonight. But that's what the past few nights have looked like for the Thunderbirds here. Head coach Steve Harrison, Kerry Ross, as well as the front office for the Thunderbirds, doing all they could to make sure to get people here, but sometimes things not necessarily work out. But now here for game two, no Vitor Banacic, no Josh Keplinger here tonight, no Mario Cavalieri, who was re-signed to a PTO yesterday. He's expected to rejoin the team on Monday. But no Vitor Banacic tonight. You heard from the head coach Steve Harrison, out indefinitely right now. He'll be reevaluated after having surgery earlier this week. No Josh Keplinger here tonight. But the Thunderbirds are here, and they're ready to go here this evening as we are getting ready for puck drop between Carolina and Baton Rouge. That's what the last few days have looked like in the Thunderbirds. And we want to thank the fans as well for your support over the past few days. Wasn't easy. All the guys wanted to be here and they wanted to be playing. And now they're ready to go here tonight. But that's what it's looked like the past two nights for the Thunderbirds. We thank you everyone for your patience and for your support here over the past few days. But hockey getting ready to go here tonight, and it should be a fun one on tap for the Carolina Thunderbirds in Baton Rouge Zydeco. We'll take a timeout and come back with more here on Thunderbirds pregame. We'll take a look at the Carolina Thunderbirds coming up on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry. We're taking...
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Welcome to Martinsville.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. The speed, the shape, the history, the hospitality, heck, even the hot dogs. A one-of-a-kind weekend at the short track of NASCAR, with trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday. It's one event too amazing to miss. NASCAR Weekend at Martinsville Speedway. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive. Or go online to flocadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Back here on Thunderbirds pregame here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Brendan Riley with you here high above the ice here at the Raising Cane's River Center for game 2 of 3 this weekend between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Carolina coming off of the loss last night, now looking to respond here this evening, something they have done so well here this year. Carolina, though, since the start of February, they had gone on a tear. Carolina was terrific throughout the month of February here this season, where they continue to, after going 4-3-1 there in the month of January, they're able to take 6 of 8 there in the month of February, including a sweep of the Danbury hat tricks, as well as sweep of the Blue Ridge Bobcats as well. And now tonight, they're looking to be able to get back to their winning ways here this evening. We take a look at the roster here tonight. Just mentioned no Peter Vanacek tonight, no Josh Keplinger as well. One newcomer to the roster here this week, and that is Chris Sielek, who was signed earlier this week after he was waived by the Blue Ridge Bobcats. The Iowa State auction product out of Buffalo, New York, had 2 goals and 7 assists in 9 games for the Blue Ridge Bobcats here this year. He'll be joining Nate Keeley and Jacob Schnapp on the third line here this evening. Roman Kramer, Jan Salak, and Yuri Pastuka make up the second line with the three forwards who played last night, John Batita, Gus Ford, and Dawson Baker, all rounding out the 9 forwards here this evening. Baker last night, he ended up getting his 20th goal of the season. That ties a single season high for the Baltimore, Ontario native for Dawson Baker. Gus Ford, another good night last night, finding the back of that. John Batita with 2 assists a night ago. The defenseman, 7 defensemen here tonight for the head coach, Steve Harrison, starting with Joe Kennedy and Tucker Firth, James Farmer and Justin Bione, with Clay Keeley, Curtis Heggie, and Gordon Whalen comprising of the 7 defensemen here this evening. And the starting netminder for the Carolina Thunderbirds here tonight, starting his second game in a row, is Cody Karpinski, coming in to this evening with a 6-5-0 record, a .320 goals against average, and an .891 save percentage. Last night, he saved 45 out of 49 shots, one of the 5 goals being an empty netter last night. So Carolina back to full strength here this evening, and they should be able to turn it up and hopefully try to be able to come away with a similar result that we saw last Friday back at the Annex in their second shutout victory of the season. A good crowd starting to fill in here at the Raising Cane's River Center as we are closing in on puck drop. Carolina in Baton Rouge for the third time this year. Take a look at the home side, the Baton Rouge Zydeco, on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others, to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go Birds!
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor. And she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com. Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Here on Thunderbirds pregame, we are getting ready. Carolina in Baton Rouge for the third time this season. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Taking a look at the Baton Rouge Zydeco coming in to this evening. Last night, their first home game in nearly 2 months. And now they're trying to be able to give the home crowd something to cheer about here tonight. Carolina looking for a different version of that here tonight. They come in tonight with a record of 9-25-4. They have 30 points and are in last place in the Continental Division of the FPHL. They are being led here this season by MJ Graham, who's got 10 goals and 19 assists here this year. Curtis Hansen's got 2, 21, and 23. This team here this season at home is 6, 11, and 1. Carolina on the other side, 9, 8, and 0 here this season. Baton Rouge here in their inaugural season here this year. Looks like they're going to be going with Bailey Stevens here tonight in net for the Zydeco. Baton Rouge, they are trying to be able to figure out the discipline a little bit. Second most penalized team in the conference with 841 penalty minutes, just behind Mississippi. Last two games, they totaled 55 penalty minutes here this year. It was that 19-game road trip where they went 3-15-1. They were able to take down the Carolina Thunderbirds, who only had 6 rostered players. Got some help last night, and now the Thunderbirds are trying to be able to take care of business here this evening against the Baton Rouge Zydeco. This is game 3 of 10 between the two sides. Carolina only 18 more games, including this one here tonight, all against the Continental Division, and it's going to be a grind all the way to the end. Another interesting weekend next weekend as well, when Carolina, they play on Friday in Columbus, and then they play the Zydeco team at home on Saturday and Sunday. We are closing in on puck drop. Carolina in Baton Rouge here this for the third time this season. Down here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. First trip in the regular season for Carolina down here to Baton Rouge. John Vale pick up 3 points here this evening as the Thunderbirds are closing in on clinching a playoff spot here for the 2023-2024 Commissioner Cup playoffs. Thunderbirds in the Zydeco getting close to getting ready to come out onto the ice here this evening. We are moving in on puck drop. Carolina and Baton Rouge coming up here in just a little bit. We'll take another timeout and come back with more here on Thunderbirds pregame after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Flo Cadillac is a proud sponsor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Visit 1400 South Stratford Road for a free test drive, or go online to flocadillac.com to schedule a sales or service appointment.
Back here in Baton Rouge, getting ready for Carolina and the Zydeco here this evening. Just about 14 minutes show on the video board here at the Raising Cane's River Center. So it looks like we are in a little bit of a delay here this evening with puck drop here from Baton Rouge. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. With extra time, we can take a look at the scores around the rest of the FPHL here this evening. First, we will start with one that got underway at 8.05 p.m. Eastern Time at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Columbus and Mississippi from Biloxi, and it's been all Columbus over the first 14.5 minutes so far. It was Nolan Slahenko with assists from Austin Doe and Josh Petrantonio. 2.5 minutes in, they gave the River Dragons a 1-0 lead. Just about over 2 minutes later, Cody Wickline with another assist from Austin Doe and Justin McDonald made it a 2-0 game in favor of Columbus before Doe finally found the back of the net after having assists on the first two. He got assists from Nolan Slahenko and Josh Petrantonio at the 12:15 mark to make it a 3-0 game there in that one, and that is where they stand about 14.5 minutes into the first period there at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Columbus with a 3-0 lead over the Mississippi Seawolves. Blue Ridge in Motor City from Big Boy Arena. And they're into the second period there in Fraser, Michigan for another matchup between these two sides. And it's Motor City with a 1-0 lead. It was Josh Colton at the 5:44 mark of period number one that got the Rockers ahead 1-0 there in that one. Blue Ridge out shooting Motor City 15-13, but it's the Rockers with a 1-0 lead there in that one. As Motor City currently sitting in second in the Empire Division, Trevor Babin has saved all 15 shots that he's seen so far here this evening. Port Huron in Danbury from the Danbury Arena in Danbury, Connecticut. And they're through the first 20 minutes of action there in the Nutmeg State. And it's Port Huron with a 3-2 lead over the Danbury Hatricks, who is 2 to start off the game in under a minute for Danbury. It was Brandon Stoyshevsky at the 8:14 mark with assists from Michael Falenga and Bodan Zinchenko. They made a 1-0 hat-tricks lead. Chase Harwell, he doubled the lead with assists from Samuel Tetro at the 9:09 mark. But from there, it was Liam Freeborn with assists from Austin Federley that cut the Danbury lead in half. Federley then tied it up with Matt Graham and Freeborn getting assists to tie it up at 2 at the 12:48 mark. Toward the 15:25 mark on the power play, Alex Johnson gave Port Huron a 3-2 lead, and that is where they stand at the Danbury Arena in Danbury, Connecticut. And then from the first arena in Elmira, New York, Binghamton in Elmira, battling once again an upstate New York battle, and they're closing in on the end of the second period. It's the Elmira River Sharks with a 3-1 lead over the Binghamton Black Bears. Dominic Dumas, the former Thunderbird, found the back of the net 30 seconds in to the second period to give Elmira the 1-0 lead there in that one with assists from Cameron Yarwood and Darius Davidson. About 7 minutes later, Cameron Clark ended up tying the game up for Binghamton. Dan Weaver and Jesse Anderson on the assist before David Gaeta. And Martin Passar ended up making it a 3-1 game in favor of Elmira. They have that lead right now with less than a minute to go in the second period there from First Arena in Elmira, New York. The River Sharks trying to come away with a victory against Binghamton. Taking a look at the standings in the FPHL here tonight. Taking a look. Columbus currently sitting in first place with 95 points on the season, 32-4-2 here this year. You got Carolina in second with 78 points there, 19 clear of Port Huron, who sit in third with a 19-14-5 record with 59 points. Mississippi playing their 41st game tonight. They have a record of 18-19-3 here this season with 53 points. You got Blue Ridge, who sits at 12-23-5. Then you have Baton Rouge in last place in the division with a 9-25-4 record with 30 points. On the other side, Binghamton, they hold a record of 28-5-6, 88 points here this season, playing in their 40th game here tonight. Rest of the divisions all played 41 games. Watertown off tonight. Got Motor City with 68 points with the 23-14-4 record. Danbury 61 points, currently sitting in third for the defending champions with 21 wins, 16 losses, and 4 overtime losses. Then you have Elmira, who are 7 clear of Watertown for that final playoff spot there in the Empire Division with 46 points and the 16-25-0 record. They are the only team in the FPHL to not lose in overtime here this season. And then Watertown with a record of 12-24-5 with 39 points here this year. Carolina, they are trying to be able to pick up their first win of March here this year. Try to be able to come away with another victory here against this Baton Rouge Zydeco team. Third ever meeting between the two sides. 8-0 shutout victory last Friday for Carolina. And then last night, the 5-3 victory for Baton Rouge here over the Carolina Thunderbirds. Carolina this season on the road here in 2023-2024 are 9-8-0. At home, they continue to be impressive back at the Annex with a record of 18-2-1. Carolina comes into tonight sitting at 23% on the power play and on the penalty kill at 74.4%. They have the goal differential of plus 48, which is good for third best in the FBHL. You look at goals allowed, though, talking with head coach Steve Harrison earlier this week. Goals allowed tells a big story. Columbus, 201 goals for, 101 goals against. That's a plus 100 goal differential. On the other side, Carolina, 151 goals for, but only 103 goals allowed. So two less goals allowed than the Columbus River Dragons with the plus 48 goal differential. So that's something to look at here as the final 17-18 games of the season continue to roll along, and especially something to look at when you get into the playoffs. It'll be high-flying and high-scoring, but the net minding and the defense, that's what wins you championships. And that's what Carolina has hung their hat on here this year. It's been the goaltending, the defense, the attack has been great as well. We look at those goals allowed, and Carolina has been terrific here this season with the second least amount of goals allowed here this year. Turning in to Columbus, who have clinched the division or clinched a playoff spot already here this year. Carolina closing in on clinching a playoff spot here soon. On the other side, Binghamton's already clinched a playoff spot, but spot's still up for grabs here in the FBHL. But Carolina right now, they're looking like they're pretty much locked in to that number two spot unless something was to happen here over these last month and a half of the season here this year. They're starting to get the blow-up ready here at the Raising Cane's River Center, and we are closing in on puck drop here for the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Baton Rouge Zydeco. The time has gone off the video board. It's the only place here in Baton Rouge that you can see the time that has gone off the clock. So not necessarily 100% sure. Last we saw was about 7 minutes remaining on the clock, so we should be closing in on a puck drop here shortly from the Raising Cane's River Center, an extended Thunderbirds pregame here tonight. Thanks for joining us here on your Friday evening. This one going to drop a little closer to 9 p.m. back in Winston-Salem at 8:30. Tomorrow night at 8 p.m. Eastern, puck drop pregame coverage starting at 7:30 for Carolina. In Baton Rouge, game number three at Carolina, hoping to make that a rubber match coming up tomorrow here in this 3-3. The schedule doesn't get easier, especially the travel for this Thunderbirds team here as we go into the final third of the season. Talked about it in Columbus next week on Friday, back home Saturday, Sunday, then a 3-3 up in Whitville against the Blue Ridge Bobcats for returning home for three straight at the end of the month for this Thunderbirds team. Carolina and Baton Rouge coming up here in just a little bit. We'll take a timeout and come back with hopefully the National Anthem puck drop. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day. And when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker. One with big heart, they were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start. From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score. So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
when it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where
we're back in Baton Rouge. We are getting set for puck drop between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Steve Harrison has taken the bench, and his team getting ready to come out onto the ice for the first time here this evening. It's game 2 and 3 here this weekend between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Baton Rouge Zydeco, and it's great to have you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Brendan Rowley with you here on your Friday evening, high above the ice here at the Raising Cane's River Center as the Thunderbirds are led out by their starting netminder here this evening, Cody Karpinski, as the Thunderbirds are looking to try to be able to come away here this season with win number 29 and move up to 81 points here this season. On the other side, the Baton Rouge Zydeco come into tonight with a record of 9-25-4 with 30 points here in their inaugural season in the FPHL. The officials now ready to come out onto the ice here this evening as it shows about 90 seconds left on the scoreboard here at the Raising Cane's River Center. An extended Thunderbirds pregame here tonight as we went into a delay. It was supposed to be a scheduled 7:30 puck drop here tonight. A little bit of delay here this evening to get things going. A much awaited game after the events of the past few nights. Carolina here this season led by the head coach Steve Harrison. Steve Harrison here in his career, a record of 195, 128, and 17. He's got a record of 28-9-1 here this season. The all-time series is even at a game apiece. On the other side, the head coach for the Baton Rouge Zydeco is Everett Thompson. He was player assistant coach for Motor City last season, former Carolina Thunderbird as well. And now here for Everett Thompson, he was just assigned last week ahead of Friday night's matchup between Carolina and Baton Rouge. Ended up picking up his first win last weekend over the Blue Ridge Bobcats. And so now the Zydeco getting ready to come out on the ice here tonight in front of a home crowd that is making their way in here to Baton Rouge. Thunderbirds here tonight in their white sweaters, no Bone Crusher uniforms that you saw last night. So Carolina, they're looking to respond here this evening. The starters for that coach Steve Harrison here tonight, it'll be John Batita, Gus Ford, and Dawson Baker. Cody Karpinski is the netminder. Tucker Firth and Joe Kennedy are the defensemen for the head coach Steve Harrison here tonight. Took a lot to get down here. And now Carolina, they're trying to be able to come away with a victory here this evening. The lights have gone down here at the Raising Cane's River Center. And then Zydeco getting ready to come out onto the ice for the first time here this evening. For Carolina, their road record here this season, 9-8-0. Only their 8th road loss. 8 of their 10 losses have come on the road here this season. As the Zydeco are waiting at their tunnel. Make their way out here. Raising Cane's River Center. An interesting setup here in the upper bowl. Really full. Holds 7,750 people for hockey when the Kingfish played. Back in the day, it was called the Riverside Centroplex, which stood from 1977 to 2004. Their next home game after this one, well, they have to wait another month, all the way until March 29th. after tomorrow's game coming up at 8 p.m. Eastern. They will head back on the road as well. They go to see the Mississippi Seawolves on the 8th. Then they come to Carolina on the 9th and the 10th before they head to Columbus to see the River Dragons for a 3-3 the following weekend. MJ Graham announced as one of the starters here this evening for the Baton Rouge Zydeco as the pregame festivities continue to roll along. So long awaited for this Thunderbirds team, and now they're going to try to be able to pick up 3 points here this evening. Good to see a full bench back for Carolina here tonight. Goal for him tonight, and he would set a new career high. Carolina's led led by the head coach, Steve Harrison, and they have the netminder, Cody Karpinski, in net here this evening. 6-5-0 for the Chicago, Illinois, native at 3.93 goals against average and an 898 save percentage. Last night, he saved 45 out of 49 shots. On the other side for the Baton Rouge Zydeco, they will go with Greg Hardy in net here this evening. 0-5-0 here this year, 495 goals against average and an 895 save percentage. They will have Nick Gonzola, MJ Grimm, as well as Curtis Hansen, Austin Weber, and Michael Civic. They are the starters for the Baton Rouge Zydeco and their head coach, Everett Thompson, here this evening. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WCOV. It should be a fun one here tonight for Carolina and Baton Rouge here on your Friday evening. We'll wait for the rest of the lights to make their way back on here.
Harrison Pace.
facing his bench. We approach 8 o'clock here in Baton Rouge, 9 o'clock back in Winston-Salem. We're settling in for a late night. For those of you back on the East Coast in Winston-Salem. Carolina, no Peter Bonacci tonight. No Josh Geblinger, no Mario Cavalieri. Cavalieri expects to rejoin the team on Monday. Peoria Riverman of the SPHL. Josh Geblinger did not make the trip. Peter Bonacci is out indefinitely at the moment after he had surgery earlier this week. Head coach Steve Bearson is going to get an update coming up on Monday. Side to Ford. Ford, who picked up a goal last night, gets taken down in the corner by Nick Katola, who's just signed last weekend. Baker picks it up, though. He holds near side, sends it to Tucker Firth. His shot gets deflected and goes into the protective netting for our first stoppage this evening, just 30 seconds in. Starting netminder here tonight is Greg Hardy, the East Haven, Connecticut native, 05-0 with a .495 goals against average and a .895 save percentage. Did not play last night. The faceoff is won in the defensive zone. And wrapped over far side. Quick pass goes off of the stick of Yuri Pastuca. Trickles back in near corner. Picking it up is Michael Haskins and holds behind his own cage. 19:15 to go, just 45 seconds in here on a Friday evening at the Raising Cane's River Center. A pass chipped off of the glass, comes all the way back to a backtracking Justin Bione. Knocks it back to center ice where Jan Salak fires it near side for Yuri Pastuca. Pastuca trying to get it back to Salak, who is crashing the net. Pastuca picks it up on the backhand, throws it out in front, and it's knocked away by Edgars Ozolinch. As Bione tries to play it back in his own defensive zone, throws a pass all the way down. Kramer chases after it, but it'll be our first icing here this evening with 18:49 to go here in the first. WTOV needs 10 seconds for station identification. We'll do that right here. This is Thunderbirds Hockey. To the right of Cody Karpinski. It comes all the way back out to the neutral zone. Here comes Yuri Pastuca, had a seat up the far side. A shot's blocked by Hardy, and he freezes here. It's 18:40 to go in period number one. It's a good break there after the defensive zone face-off draw for Carolina. They get our first shot here this evening. Slow start here in this one. Faceoff goes into the corner. Chris Selak, who was just signed earlier this week, battles for it. Nate Keeley steps up as Clay Keeley also pinches down from his defense position. Austin Weber dancing through center ice. Walks in, drops it off near side for Bradley Richardson. And head shot saved by Karpinski, who freezes here at 18:22 to go. Karpinski last night, he was good, saved 45 out of 49 shots in the 5-3 loss. Faceoff is won by Baton Rouge. It's Tyler Larwood battling for it, rattles it around, picking it up is Bradley Richardson. He's pinned to the boards by Clay Keeley. Trying to step in and take it away was Nate, but it's ricocheted back out to the neutral zone. Schnapp tries to backhand it along, just gets past the red line. For Seelan, touches this one in, past Nick Catola, into the corner. Larwood gets rid of it. Takes a check from Schnapp. Scatola dispossessed by Seelick. It's wrapped over far side by Michael Sivek. And a quick stretch pass. Here comes Austin Weber. Near side, a shot and a save by Karpinski, who freezes with 17:48 to go here in the first. Quick stretch pass there. Good look for Austin Weber. Coming into tonight on a three-game point streak with four assists over that stretch. Six goals for the forward. Face off to the left of Karpinski. Gus Ford takes it away and he holds. Plays it past the blue sweater over to the far side. Tucker Firth chases after it into the corner. Poked back out to the top of the dots. A quick shot from the points. Knocked down. Now Scott Chirac trying to get it away. Battling for the puck. Chirac takes it away. Fires it over to Noah Robinson. His pass goes off of the skates of Tucker Firth. Batita trying to go cross ice. Instead, Haskins picks it up and backtracks and slides it over far side to Ozolinch. Puck ricochets high in the air as Haskins picks it back up. Just under 3 minutes in here in period number one between Carolina and Baton Rouge. This first line out there, Batita, Baker, and Ford. Baker and Ford make their way back to the bench. Playing nearly 40 minutes last night. They get off quickly. Kennedy goes all the way back down to pick it up in the corner, being pressured by Chirac. Kennedy takes it away, slides it to Jan Salak. Quick touch pass to Yuri Pastuca, tries to chip it along, goes off of a man, and Pastuca slides it over to Roman Kramer. Kramer across the blue line, a quick shot, save, rebound near side, getting the right pad there, was the netminder Harney. They battle for it still, and it comes back out to Kramer. Big save there by Greg Harney. A couple of good chances for Carolina as Salak keeps it in, tries to fire it down low to Pastuca. Instead, it's played over on the far side by Thomas McGuire. James Farmer picks it back up, flips a pass to Jan Salak, who's right back into the attacking zone. Salak spins around Kitsola on the back end. He has it on the far side. Searching, plays it, and cycles it back down to Kramer. Drops it off for Pastuca, puts the blinders on. Still has it, battling against McGuire. Pass chipped up in the air as McGuire and Salak battle for it over in the far corner. 16 minutes to go here in the first period. Carolina and Baton Rouge scoreless so far here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Kramer comes away with the puck. It's tied up at the kick plate. A man goes falling to the ground. That's Katsola. Salak trying to dance his way out of danger. Has it behind the net. Salak, man loses his stick. Salak still battling for it over in the near corner. Takes a check. As now it's still tangled up. And McGuire's able to fire it up to MJ Graham. But a nice shot by Justin Bione stepping up at the red line and knocking it free. Kramer still has it. Long shift for this second line as it's dumped back in on the netminder Harney. 15:25 to go here in the first period. Still a scoreless game. Here in game 2 of 3 this weekend. Haskins from behind his own net. Floats one all the way to Clay Keeley. Knocks it down. Dispossessed of the neutral zone. Schnapp going over near side, battling for it. Telstrom shovels it back to Haskins, who fires it over far side, and a pass is intercepted as Schnapp works his way into the zone. Sends it over to Selick, gets by a man, puts the blinders on, and sends it back out to the point. Clay Keeley, he waits. His shot goes off of his twin brother Nate's stick, and it pops free to the neutral zone. Here comes Tyler Larwood. He floats it in, picks it back up at the blue line. Near dot, a shot, and it's blocked by Clay Keeley. Graham Whalen plays it off the far half boards. Matthew Bazarin cycles it back in. No one in a blue setter at home, though, as Keeley fires it near side. Selick right back to Clay Keeley. 14:35 to go here in the first period. Clay will dump this one in as him and Bazarin collide at the blue line, and it's back tapped all the way to Haskins. Far side. Edgars Ozelinch plays a pass off of the boards, waiting for it's Telstrom trying to back in. It's Chirac, comes all the way down in on Karpinski, rattles it off of the boards, picking it up and sliding it up to John Batito as Tucker Firth. Batito's pirouettes away, tries to fire one far side to Baker. Kennedy has it, a shot and a save off of the mask by Hardy. Good look there for Joe Kennedy. Walking and having plenty of noise, or plenty of space walking in. Jake Cox touches this one in. After he got past the red line, Firth gets rid of it to Dawson Baker. It's loose at the near point. Goss Ford battling for it, trying to shovel along to Batito. Him and Noah Robinson tangle up. Robinson back in the attacking zone. His shot parried away by Karpinski. They battle for it. Jake Cox knocks it down, has it on the back end, floats it out in front. Firth able to come across. A rebound attempt saved by Karpinski, who covers here with 13:33 remaining in period number one. Off to a interesting start here in Baton Rouge. A couple good looks for the Thunderbirds, but right now we're scoreless. We're 13:33 to go in period number one. We're back to the Raising Cane's River Center on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Welcome to Martinsville.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. The speed, the shape, the history, the hospitality, heck, even the hot dogs. A one-of-a-kind weekend at the short track of NASCAR with trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday. It's one event too amazing to miss. NASCAR weekend at Martinsville Speedway. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
We're back here in Baton Rouge. We're scoreless here between the Zydeco and Thunderbirds with 13:33 remaining here in the first bank, first period. Brandon Riley with you here high above the ice here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Kind of tucked away in the corner here at the Raising Cane's River Center, standing directly over the Thunderbirds attacking zone. About a diagonal from the Thunderbirds bench. As now, looks like we have another looks like they're looking at a stanchion of the glass. Shots are 3-3 in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. Here with us on Thunderbirds pregame, head coach Steve Harrison said he had to see how his team would come out. Hasn't been pedal to the metal quite yet. Have to work into a little bit. And it'll be a face-off to the right of Cody Karpinski. It'll be Gus Ford for the draw against Curtis Hansen. Carolina in the first period here this year. They've been good. They're looking at trying to be able to add to that tally now here going in. With 13:33 remaining here in the first period, Ford wins the the draw back to Tucker Firth, who wraps it near side to John Petita. Hops hard off of his skates, pokes free over to MJ Graham. Graham backhands it along. Ford will intercept behind Karpinski's cage. Trying to float it along, takes a deflection. Kennedy gloves it down. A one-hand pass over to Dawson Baker, sitting on 20 goals here this year. Baker, a backhand, throws one in, goes off of the skate of Kennedy. He doesn't know where the puck is before Petita, trying to poke it away. Tangles up against Nick Kitsola. Still battle for it in the corner. Petita takes it back up. He had a two assist last night. And it's floated back out. Kennedy knocks it down right on the blue line. He still has it. Backhands it across. Hansen's able to clear the zone as Ford picks it back up. He backtracks all the way into his own defensive zone. Surveys his options. He's got Curtis Hansen pressuring him. Spins away from him and fires it over to Yuri Pastuca. Pastuca into the attacking zone. Drops it off for Petita. Petita on the backhand to Pastuca behind the net. He lost an edge behind the cage. And picking it up is Hansen, who flips it all the way out to the neutral zone. Farmer tried to glove it down. Instead, left it for Justin Bione. Banks a pass off of the penalty box's boards, and it's rattled all the way in. McGuire forgot the puck. Here's Salak trying to work his way through the slot. Wraps back out for side. Pastuca holding as his pass chip and go out of play. To about the fourth row here at 12-10 remaining in the first period. So Carolina so far is spending the majority of the time here early on in the attacking zone. And some high quality chances. This line of Kramer, Salak, and Pastuca had a pretty good opportunity right on the doorstep. Greg Harney went down to the splits though. Be able to make the save. Faceoffs won by Baton Rouge. Telstrom in the neutral zone as Jan Salak run him down. Justin Bione flips it right over Telstrom. Kramer trying to battle for the loose puck. He takes it and dumps it in. Thunderbirds will chase after it here with 11:54 to go in the first period. Salak in the corner trying to float one along. A delayed high stick, as they said Kramer played it with a high stick. They say Bione touched it before Matthias Telstrom got a touch, so he'll bring it back out. 11:47 to go here in the first period. I'll bring up a faceoff in the Thunderbirds' defensive zone. Saw last night Gus Ford, he was giving a game misconduct penalty to not get a suspension from the FPHL. Faceoff to the left of Karpinski. Nate Keeley tangles up. Gordon Whalen steps in to play it off of the inboards. Comes back out to the near point. It's Robinson. Drops it off. Working in Chirac on the backhand. Whalen cuts him off, and Schnott picks it back up. Zips it over near side. Curtis Heggie waits for it. Backhands the pass all the way out to the neutral zone. This one gets deflected out of play once again. And a stoppage here with 11:25 to go. Carolina, seven defensemen here tonight. Faceoff coming at center ice. You got Clay Keeley, Gordon Whalen, Curtis Hagee, Nate Keeley, and Jacob Schnapp, the five out there for Carolina right now. Chirac and Nate Keeley for the draw. Tie up. Jake Cox with Schnapp pressuring him. Fires over near side. Michael Haskins. It's intercepted by Hagee, who dumps it in. Barney gets a quick touch and drops it off for Michael Civic. Civic over to Haskins. Here's approach. 11 minutes to go here in period number one. Haskins and Keeley get tangled up. Schnapp wins a one-on-one battle and fires it back out to the point to Clay Keeley. Thought about the slam shot. Comes near side. Whale and a shot and a save by Harney in the butterfly. And he freezes with 10:56 to go here in the first. Second in the Continental Division Monday night with 78 points. Columbus has already clinched a playoff spot. The faceoff is taken by Baton Rouge. It's fired out to Tyler Larwood against Kennedy. One-on-one to the outside. A backhand attempt is fought off by Karpinski. Ricocheted awkwardly off of the end glass and came back out near side. But Carolina now goes the other way with Gus Ford, who spins his way at the red line and backhands it over to Bradley Richardson. Plays a pass to the outside. Joe Kennedy takes it away and slides it to his D partner, Tucker Firth. Approach the midway mark here in period number one. We're still scoreless between Carolina and Baton Rouge. Here's Ford, a shot. It goes off of the skates of a man. Comes out in front, and they score. Dawson Baker in the right place at the right time. He gets his 21st goal of the year, setting a new season high for Dawson Baker as he gives Carolina a 1-0 lead here with 10:20 to go in the first period. Ford had a shot get deflected. It hit hard off of the end glass and came right back down in front. Harney had no chance. And Carolina here, 9 minutes and 40 seconds into this one, take a 1-0 lead here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Thanks to Dawson Baker's 21st of the season. He's now got a goal as well in each of his last five games for Dawson Baker. After coming back from Peoria Riverman, has been on an absolute tear. Back underway as Karpinski has to cover after it was dunked in from center ice. The faceoff comes to the left of Karpinski. 10-12 to go in period number one. Carolina, a 1-0 lead. Faceoff is won by Jan Salak. Played over far side. James Farmer steps up and zips it over to Roman Kramer. Plays a pass to himself on the outside. Gets past Haskins on the back end. Has it loose at his skates. Haskins angles him off, but it's left for Jan Salak. Salak beyond the goal. Battling. Spins away from a man near side. Has plenty of space trying to get it out to Yuri Pestuka. Clearing it, though, is Matthias Telstrom. That goal from Dawson Baker. A Riddle tractor goal. Farmer winds and fires. Didn't get a lot on it as it's blocked down by two. Blue sweaters in the slot. Kramer tries to get rid of it, takes it away before it's picked back up. Pestuka trying to poke it along, finds Kramer behind the net. A quick backhand pass to Salak at the near post, taking it away. Playing over on the far side is Hippolyte Smith. Goes off of the backside of Kramer. Pestuka trying to backhand it to Salak. It's loose in the slot here. Salak turns and fires, and Harney somehow just got the blocker there. Wasn't expecting the shot. Reactionary save there from Greg Harney. 1-0, Carolina in front here with 9:05 to go in the first period. Here comes MJ Graham, the near side. Graham sent into the boards by Justin Bione. Stays on his feet. Sealuck playing, expecting the hit. Gets tangled up behind the cage with Austin Weber. 8:50 to go here in the first period. Puck tied up at the kick plate. Five guys battling for it. It's taken away by Carolina. Farmer plays it up the near side. Here's Nate Keeley spinning his way, putting the brakes on, trying to dance past the man. He gets past Katola, near side, brings it behind the net, wraps out far side. The back in, plays it to Sealick, trying to settle it down one-on-one against Weber, who pins him up against the boards. Continue to battle for it. Sealek there on the inside. Schnapp comes away with it. He gets sent down from behind by Curtis Hansen. So he was trying to walk out in front. It's whipped all the way down. Karpinski wants an icing, and he'll get it here with 8:03 to go here in period number one. And that brings us to a media timeout. But Dawson Baker has the Thunderbirds on the board with his 21st goal of the season, a new career high for Baker here this in his FPHL career. Carolina leads 1-0 here with 8:03 left to go in the first. We're back after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Back here in Baton Rouge, Carolina, the 1-0 lead here on a Friday evening at the Raising Cane's River Center. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Dawson Baker has the Thunderbirds in front here in this one. His goal coming at the 9:40 mark of the first period. So Carolina enjoying an advantage right now here over this Baton Rouge Zydeco team. Gus Ford and Tucker Firth getting the assists on Dawson Baker's 21st of the season. A face-off comes to the right. To the left, to Greg Carney, and it's won by Austin Weber as we're back underway here in our first bank, first period. Here's Petita in front, a shot save, rebound attempt. Puck battling around over on the far side, and it's knocked away by Weber. Oh, a good look there for John Petita in front. The rebound, Gus Ford couldn't control. MJ Graham flips it back out to the neutral zone. Hanson trying to knock it down, going 1-on-1 against Joe Kennedy. The Seattle native wins that battle, walks up the near side. Kennedy on the forehand, trying to drag his way past Katola, who knocks it away. It's sent back in. Robinson finishes off a hit on Petita, who picks it back up near dot. Backhands it to Ford behind the net. Ford trying to hold on Katola. Goes back out to the top of the zone, drops it off for Kennedy, and gets it right back. Ford absorbs the hit, holds, and will dump this one in. Petita wraps it back out. No one was home, though, as he split the defenseman Joe Kennedy and Tucker Firth, and Firth will go back to pick it up. Five out there right now for Carolina. The netminder Cody Karpinski, the only ones that played last night, playing nearly well over half the game for both sides. Robinson dumps this one in. Here with 6:54 to go in the first period. 1-0 Carolina in front for the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Third meeting this season between the two sides. Kramer flips it to Jan Salak. Thought about a pass, but now will walk into the zone. Throws one in, and this one goes up into the protective netting, and a stoppage here with 6:38 to go. So Carolina spending, once again, a lot of time in the attacking zone. Harney led one goal, didn't have the chance on that goal from Dawson Baker. The faceoff to Harney's left. It's locked for the draw, and it comes right in on Harney. Carries it over to the near corner. Kramer intercepts, backhands it far side. Here's Pastuca dangling in as it knocked away. Farmer will have to go back out to the neutral zone to pick it up. Here's Farmer, his shot sails high over the bar. Bazarin picks it up far side, zips it over. Ozilich fires it to the far corner. It's intercepted by Pastuca. Salak spins his way back out to the half court, tries to get a pass away. Said Telstrom picks it up and leaves it far side. 6 minutes to go here in the first period. Carolina the 1-0 lead. This one's going to go all the way down, and it will go for icing. 5:54 to go in the first period. Steve Harrison will bring out fresh legs. He brings out. First, he brought out Schnott, Nate Keeley, and Chris Seelick, but now he's trying to find a second one and brings out Gus Ford, John Petita, and Dawson Baker. Ford for the draw, trying to step through. Is it knocked away, battling against Noah Hippolyte-Smith. Ford from the blue line sends one intentionally wide, drop down front. Here's Keeley, and he scores. Clay Keeley gets his second goal of the season. A beautiful play. Gus Ford sending one intentionally wide. Petita dropping it off, and Clay Keeley has the open net and doubles the lead for Carolina here at 5:43 to go in the first period. Carolina leads the Zydeco 2-0. So a good response from this Thunderbirds team here tonight. So they got the first two here this evening as this one goes out of play. Petita gets his third assist of the weekend. He's now got 16 as Ford picks up his second assist of the night for Gus Ford. He's now up to 28 here this year. Off at center ice is taken by Carolina. Gets back in it quickly. Telstrom will chase after it. Joe Kennedy picks it up and has it on the forehand. Kennedy at the red line across the Raising Cane's River Center logo brings it all the way in. A quick shot and saved by Harney, who freezes here at 5:21 to go in the first period. Thank you. sends one in from the point. Carried away by Harney. Nate Keeley picks it up, battling one-on-one. Comes away with it on the far side. Nate Keeley on the back end. Cycles it in. Sealick. Shoved off by Scott Chirac, but picks it up in the near corner. Drops it for Jacob Schnapp, who holds, goes cross ice, back out to the point. Kennedy, a shot. And Harney somehow saw it through traffic and got the glove up there to cover with 4:58 to go here in period number one. Clay Keeley, an assist from Gus Ford and John Bencita. It's doubled the Carolina lead. They lead the Baton Rouge Zydeco 2-0 here at the Raising Cane's River Center. We're back with more after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Here in Baton Rouge, Carolina leads 2-0 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco after Clay Keeley gets his second goal of the year at the 14-17 mark with assists from John Batita and Gus Ford. That goal is always brought to you by Riddle Tractor. And Carolina enjoying a 2-0 lead so far here in this one. The shots on goal in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker, 11-4 in favor of the Thunderbirds. Last night, Carolina outshot 50-24 as they have a faceoff in the attacking zone. It'll be Nate Keeley in for the draw against Jake Cox to the left of Harney. 4:58 to go. Faceoff is won into the corner by Jake Cox, who picks it back up but loses the puck. Sealick trying to dance away from a man. He's able to win a one-on-one battle and has it over the far half boards. Drops it behind the net. Nate Keeley trying to spin his way around. Cox lost an edge before Keeley picks it back up, sends it back out to the point. Whalen throws one in, takes a deflection from Sealick, and Harney's able to find that one easily in cover with 4:39 to go here in the first. Attacking zone face-off draw by Chirac and Salak. Salak wins it, but it's sent back out to the neutral zone. Here, 4.5 to go in the first period. Harry Pastuca in the neutral zone, trying to backhand one of Jan Salak as it whacked all the way back out to James Foreman. Plays it near side to Justin Bione, who's intercepted by Chirac. His pass goes Eric. Kramer drops it off for Salak on the forehand. Salak in the corner finds Pastuca, quickly over to Kramer, near side, hit shot. Saved by Harney as it's parried over into the corner. Kramer drops it back for Bione. His pass intercepted, though, by Chirac. And now here comes Baton Rouge 3-on-2 if they hurry. Chirac trying to dance past Bione. Angled him off. It's Farmer in the corner. Gets rid of it. Takes a hit. But does his job as Kramer saucers it back near side past Justin Bione. Nick Kitsola, who was just signed last week. Remember that? Six guys signed to the active roster before last Friday's game. And a new wave under the new head coach Everett Thompson for the Zydeco team. MJ Graham gets across the blue line, puts the brakes on, loses it as Baker throws it. It goes off of a man and into the Thunderbirds bench. Steve Harrison will take the puck here with 3:30 left to go in the first. Shots. Carolina. Shooting batters, 13-4. This one looking a little bit more like the matchup we saw last Friday back in the annex. Carolina picking up their second shutout victory of the season. Face off in front of their bench. It's won by Gus Ford as Carolina looks to go the other way. Firth gets across the red line and dumps it in over on the far side. Austin Baker throws it high off of the glass. Gus Ford picks it up on the near side. It's Ford battling one-on-one against Haskins. Wins the battle, has it on the back end at the far dot, plays it back out to Joe Kennedy. His shot through traffic, knocked down by Weber, but Petita on him. Weber goes for the pass through the crease over to Civic. His pass intercepted. Here's Gus Ford trying to dance his way through, but it's knocked away as Weber will clear the zone. Larwood chasing after Kennedy over in the far corner. It's left for Tucker Firth. Too much on that pass for Dawson Baker, but Larwood couldn't make him pay. Ford in the neutral zone with 2:43 to go here in the first period. Ford spinning his way in his own defensive zone. Baton Rouge in the midst of a change. Ford dingles past the man to the outside. He'll bring it into the attacking zone. He's got Batita and Baker with him. In the near corner, Batita takes a loose puck, finds Baker top of the dots into the slot. He got hit. No call as he lost his stick, and it's fired all the way down. Baker wanted the call. Looked like he might have been slashed, but no call as we continue a 5-on-5 here with 2:09 to go in the first period. That was a prime spot for Dawson Baker, one that we've seen him score from so many times here this year. But 2 minutes to go here in the first period. Carolina leads 2-0 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. This one trickles in all the way on the netminder. Harney will play it, and he'll cover here with 1:54 to go in the first period. Faceoff comes to the left of Harney. You got Jake Cox and Nate Keeley for the draw. Faceoff tangled up for once again. Keeley trying to dance through. Puck ricochets high in the air. Harney got a glove to it. He lost it. Nate Keeley picks it back up. Spins his way back to the outside. Battling against Noah Robinson. Throws it over to the near half boards. Gordon Whalen stepping up. Gets tangled up at the near half boards. Selick wins the battle. Fires it over far side. Clay Keeley's already got a goal tonight. Centers one trying to find Nate. And instead, Katola able to thwart the scoring opportunity. 1:22 to go here in the first period. Cross ice pass, Schnapp backhands this one wide, picks it up behind the net, trying to find Sielek in front, goes off of a man, picks it up though regardless. Pass back out to the point, Whalen a shot, and that one saved by Harney. Ended up getting it off the glove, almost trickled in at the far side, instead went harmlessly into the corner. Now in front, Schrock picks it up under a minute to go here in the first period. Carolina 2, Baton Rouge nothing. In the second of three here this weekend, just off of the bench is Roman Kramer. He intercepts, works his way back into the zone, dances to the outside. Kramer on the forehand, brings it behind the cage, holding, fires it out to Bioni. Top of the dots, a shot, and he hit the bar. Rebound still loose, though. Kramer finds it. His shot is knocked down in front. He gloves it down, though, keeps it in. 34 seconds to go here in the first period. He chases after again. He's been everywhere here on this shift. Salak drops it off. Bioni thought about the shot. His shot on the second attempt. Parried away by Harney. Jake Cox picks it up over on the far side. 20 seconds to go here in the first period. Carolina 2. Baton Rouge nothing. Almost 3 after the Thunderbirds just hit the crossbar. Bioni and Schrock, they collide as Bioni dumps it in. Katola. Salak lost an edge in the corner here at 4:03, 2:01. Will they get the icing? No, they will not. And that will do it for period number one here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina with a 2-0 advantage here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco after the first 20 minutes of action here on a Friday evening in the Bayou. Carolina 2, Baton Rouge nothing. After the first 20 minutes, it was Dawson Baker with an assist from Gus Ford and Tucker Firth at the 9:40 mark, and John and Clay Keeley with assist from John Batita and Gus Ford, giving Carolina the 2-0 lead. Thunderbirds will make their way to the bench and hear from head coach Steve Harrison. Get ready for the start of period number two. But Carolina with the 2-0 advantage here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco after the first 20 minutes of action. We'll take a timeout and come back with the first intermission report on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Raybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go, Birds!
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
We're back here in Baton Rouge, and the Carolina Thunderbirds enjoy a 2-0 lead over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. In that first period, Carolina found the back of the net twice last night. They had three, but it was tied at three tonight. A much different story here this evening as Carolina, they have been able to control a majority of this game. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, back in our WTOB studios. Great to have you along here in your Friday evening. A late start here tonight. It was supposed to be a 7:30 local time, 8:30 Eastern time puck drop. We were pushed back until about 7:54 local time here in Biloxi, so about a 45-minute-plus pregame. And so now the Thunderbirds, they have the 2-0 lead here for the first 20 minutes. How did we get there? Well, both sides really figuring each other out there over the first 5-plus minutes or so. At the first media timeout, it was 3-3 in the shots on goal department for both sides. And then after that first media timeout, Carolina, they started to take over. And at the 9:40 mark, it was Dawson Baker with an assist from Gus Ford and Tucker Firth that gave Carolina the 1-0 lead. That goal for Dawson Baker, his 21st of the season, setting a new career high here in his third season with Carolina. He's now got a goal in each of his last 5 games coming into this evening for Dawson Baker here in his third season. He's been good so far here tonight, and he's been great as of late since his return from the Peoria Rivermen of the SPHL. So Carolina had the 1-0 lead, and they held that lead. And that was about 5:45 to go there in the first period. Carolina, they found another, and this time it came from the first line, and it was Clay Keeley. Gus Ford went all the way back to the blue line, sent one intentionally wide, a heads-up play there by Gus Ford. Banked off of the end boards, John Petita, he was able to pick it up. He slid it for Clay Keeley, who was crashing into the high slot, and Keeley had open net. And it gave Carolina the 2-0 lead. That first goal from Dawson Baker was a shot from Gus Ford that got deflected. It ricocheted hard off of the end glass and ended up right out in front. And Baker is able to find the back of the net as Carolina, they lead the Baton Rouge Zydeco by a score of 2-0 here in this one. The shots on goal in our first 20 minutes of action in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. It's Carolina with a 16-4. Advantage in the shots on goal department. If you looked at last night's matchup between these two sides, you saw a much different story. Last night, Carolina was outshot 20-5 in the second period and 16-7 in the third. Tonight, though, with the full roster back in action, they're looking like like the Carolina Thunderbirds of old. As the defense has been good, Cody Karpinski, only four shots he saw in that first period, saving all four. On the other side, Greg Harney has saved 14 out of 16. Carolina's gotten the bounces that have been able to give them the 2-0 lead. But that is sometimes all you need. No penalties for either side over the first 20 minutes. This Baton Rouge team, second most penalized team in the division with 841 penalty minutes, just behind Mississippi. In the last two games, they have a total of 55 penalty minutes. On the other side, Carolina, second most disciplined team in the FBHL, only behind Columbus with 659 minutes. Carolina averaging about 16 minutes per game here in 2023-2024. So Carolina has looked good so far here tonight. They have the 2-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco in the third ever meeting between the two sides. Carolina trying to move back ahead in the all-time series and the season series here between these two sides. Carolina leads 2-0 here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco after the first 20 minutes. Coming up next, we'll take a look around the rest of the FBHL. We'll have a new edition of Kid Six coming up during tomorrow night's broadcast. But right now, it is a 2-0 lead for Carolina here in this one. And we're back with more on the first intermission report after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
First intermission here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina leads Baton Rouge by a score of 2-0. It was Dawson Baker getting his 21st of the year to make it a 1-0 game. And then Clay Keeley getting his second of his FBHL career made it 2-0. That's where the Thunderbirds sit right now here in this one. Taking a look around the rest of the FBHL here this evening, about 9 minutes or so, give or take, until the start of period number two. St. Pony's just getting out on the ice right now. Take a look around the rest of the FBHL here. Tonight we start with the Columbus River Dragons, Mississippi Seawolves from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. And this one's all Columbus down in Biloxi. Four in the first for Columbus. It was three the last time we checked pregame. Alexander Jamea found the back of the net with about 4:15 to go there. And rather 5:15 to go there in period number one. That made it a 4-0 game. Joaquim Nielsen got the lead to 3 at the 7-11 mark there in the second period for Justin McDonald. Ended up making a 5-1 game there. 15:34 to go there in period number one, or in period number two. And right now they're at the second intermission, and it's Columbus with a 5-1 lead over the Mississippi Seawolves. Looking elsewhere, got a good one late there at Big Boy Arena. Blue Ridge and Motor City in a battle right now. Motor City in a 1-0 lead after one. They led 2-0 about 6 minutes into the second before Cody Oaks ended up making a 2-1 game in the 9:21 mark. Then in the third period, Nikita Ivashkin ends up tying the game up at two. That is where they sit now with 2 minutes to go in the third period up in Fraser, Michigan at Big Boy Arena. They're tied at two between Blue Ridge and Motor City there from Big Boy Arena. Elsewhere, good one in Danbury, Connecticut. Danbury and Port Huron in a battle right now, just over a minute into the third period. Port Huron held a 3-2 lead after the first 20 minutes of action. Danbury got the first two before Port Huron responded with three goals. They took that 3-2 lead to the second, but Johnny Ruiz and Josh LaBelle have given Danbury the lead there in the second period. They lead 4-3 over the Port Huron Prowlers as they're about 80 seconds into the third period there from the Danbury Ice Arena. And then the last game on the evening here tonight is from First Arena up in Elmira, New York. And how about Dominic Dumas getting first star honors for the Elmira River Sharks tonight against the Binghamton Black Bears. Dumas, a goal and an assist here this evening. He got the scoring started, then ended up getting an assist on Darius Davidson's goal at the 15:31 mark there as Elmira and Binghamton. A loss here tonight by a final score of 6-3. Dumas, first star. Sammy Bernard gets second star. Trevor Newman, who had two assists, gets the third star. But a good night there for Elmira, who take 3 points over the Binghamton Black Bears there in that one. So that's a look around the rest of the FPHL here this evening. We got about 6.5 minutes until the start of period number two, and it's the Thunderbirds with a 2-0 lead here for the Baton Rouge Zydeco. We reset things for the start of the second period on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Welcome to Martinsville.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. The speed, the shape, the history, the hospitality, heck, even the hot dogs. A one-of-a-kind weekend at the short track of NASCAR with trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday. It's one event too amazing to miss. NASCAR weekend at Martinsville Speedway. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Once upon a time, not so far away, two heroes found the secret to a perfect game day. They had heard of a baker, one with big heart. They were thrilled he had the answer. Ava's Cupcakes is where he's set to start.
From cakes to cookies, cupcakes, and more, we've got flavors that'll score and score.
So the Thunderbirds cheered, ready to tell all. Ava's Cupcakes is the sweetest. Bakery to call.
Back here at the Raising Cane's River Center, Brenda Riley with you here on the first intermission report. Carolina with a 2-0 lead over the Baton Rouge Zydeco as we're closing in on the start of period number two. Carolina outshot Baton Rouge 16-4 in that first period on Contact LLC. Shots on goal tracker. Dawson Baker got his 21st of the season, his new single season high. That was previously 20 from 2 years ago. Gus Ford and Tucker Firth getting assists on the first goal of the evening on the opener for Carolina. Clay Keeley gets his second with assists from John Petita and Gus Ford at the 14-17 mark. And the Thunderbirds have a 2-0 lead. No penalties to speak of over the first 20 minutes here in this one. Cody Karpinski saved all four shots he saw here tonight. On the other side, the netminder Greg Harney saved 14 out of 16. And right now, Carolina, they have the advantage. Here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco after 20 minutes of action. Steve Harrison making his way back out to the bench, and we are getting set for the start of period number two. Carolina, the 2-0 lead, and the second period's coming up next. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Hi, I'm Stuart with Fiddlin Fish Brewing Company here in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. I'm proud to be the official craft beer of Carolina Thunderbirds since 2018. Be sure to find us on draft or in cans at the games or come down and see us. We're here in downtown Winston-Salem. Go Birds.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
Here at Comtech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring. At prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. Comtech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Back here in Baton Rouge as we are just about set for the start of period number two, which is presented by Flow Automotive. Thunderbirds have made their way back out onto the ice as we have reached the period of the long change. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Carolina, two goals in that first period. Dawson Baker and Clay Keeley both find in the back of the net. Baker getting his 21st of the season, Clay Keeley getting his second of his FPHL career, as the Thunderbirds now will try to be able to put a stranglehold on this game. Trying to be able to come away with 3 points this evening and even up the series here this weekend between the two sides. Last night, a 5-3 lead win for the Baton Rouge Zydeco. In that first period, the netminder Cody Karpinski only had to see 4 shots. Now the Thunderbirds will look, try to be able to pull away here in this one and make it an easy rest of the night. You never know in this game, but it should be a fun middle 20 coming up here for the Thunderbirds in Zydeco. Cody Karpinski saved all 4 shots he saw. Greg Harney saves 14 out of 16. Carolina looking like the Carolina we've seen ever since the start of February. Won 6 out of 8 over that stretch. 3-game win streak snap last night. The lights look like they're on. And Boney wrapped up about a minute and a half to go. As they play calling Baton Rouge here over the speakers. We're set for the start of the second period. We're underway here at the Raising Cane's River Center for period number two. Carolina 2-0 lead here in this Flow Automotive second period. Gus Ford between his legs, backhands one high over the bar. This one comes all the way back out to the near point. Joe Kenny knocks it along. Ford has it near dot. A quick shot in and out of the glove of Hardy. And picking it up is Katola. Katola trying to dance his way out of his own zone. Fires it tape to tape to Curtis Hansen. Hansen trying to get to Graham, who had a step past Firth. Instead, the Thunderbirds go the other way. Ford up the far side against Civic. Puts the blinders on. Drops it back. Batita over to Baker. Top of the slot. And the shot's blocked by Weber into the corner. Batita clubs it down behind the net. Throws it off of the skates of Katola. Civic picks it up. Brings it over far side. MJ Graham trying to get rid of it. There's the puck poked away, but a good start here for the Thunderbirds in this second period. A couple of early looks for this first line. Katola brings it behind the net, and he holds. Here's Carolina, goes off for their first change of the second period. Minute in here, period number two. 2-0 Carolina in front here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Quick pass, no one home though as it goes. Aaron James Farmer finds Roman Kramer, backhands over Pastuca in front, and he scores. Yuri Pastuca gets a goal, and now each of his last three, that's point number 298 of his FPHL career. And with 18:46 left to go here in the second period, Carolina adds to its advantage. It's 3-0 Thunderbirds. A quick turnover in the neutral zone. Farmer to Kramer. To Yuri Pastuca, who's able to backhand it home, and Carolina on the riddle track. Their goal now has a 3-0 lead here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco, and this one in the right back into the attacking zone. Kramer, his shot gets deflected off of the end boards, picking it up behind the net. Scott Chirac, his pass intercepted. Pastuca, he has it, sends it far side. Just getting a touch was Ozelinch as it's thrown back in off of the glove of Herney. Jake Cox banks a pass, picking it up on the near side. As Haskins between the legs drops it off for Jake Cox, rattles it around behind the net. Salak takes the puck away, finds Kramer, who lofts it all the way back out to the neutral zone. Kramer getting his 13th assist. He's now got four across the last two games for the Boone Township, Pennsylvania native. 2 minutes gone here in the second period. Carolina enjoying a 3-0 lead here in game two this weekend. Clay Keeley fires it over far side. Quick pass to Jacob Schnott, throws it off the skates of Nate Keeley. Now here comes Carolina. Keeley with space, walking in on the backhand, and just getting a poke was Haskins. Keeley pinned to the boards by Michael Haskins. They battle for it over on the far side. Sent back out to Clay Keeley. His shot knocked down by Jake Cox. Hippolyte Smith tried to get to it. Cox goes tumbling to the ground as Clay Keeley shovels it in. Behind the net, Nate Keeley finishes off a check of Haskins. Those two physical against each other here on this shift. As Haskins controls behind his netminder, Greg Herney. 17:50 to go here in the second period. It's Hippolyte Smith up the near side. Dances to the outside pass. Whalen on the backhand behind the cage. He has it. Fires it over far side. A quick shot from Bazarin is straight into the glove of Cody Karpinski, who freezes here with 17:05 to go here in the second period. Shooting Baton Rouge 3-0 here in this second period. They found the back of the net once with Yuri Pastuca at the 1:14 mark. Gus Ford fires a bank pass off of boards in front of the Zydeco bench. Joe Kennedy tried to control it. Said Telstrom drops it back to Kennedy right at the center ice logo. Dances to the outside. As a stick lifted, Baker chases after it though. And Hippolyte Smith shovels it back out to Kennedy at the point. Goes D to D to Earth. His shot off of a skate. Takes a high ricochet. Batita trying to control it instead of Zydeco. Trying to clear their zone, and they will as Kennedy will chase after. It's got Telstrom pressuring. Banks a pass. Right pass Bazarin. Baker and Bazarin now battling in front of the penalty boxes. Ford in the attacking zone. Dances by a man, and a nice last-ditch effort there by Thomas McGuire before Ford was almost in all alone. Batita plays it back to Tucker Firth. It's a return pass. Batita holds at the red line. Trying to get past Telstrom. Almost loses it. Curtis Hansen closing on him, but banks a pass over to Ford. Drops it for Baker. Baker in the slot. A shot in that one. Just goes wide. At the near point, it's clear. James Farmer just off of the bench. He has to wait for Baker to get to the bench as a delayed offside was pending, and it's dumped in. Thomas McGuire holds behind the cage here with 15:47 to go here in the second period. Carolina 3-0 in favor here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco in the third meeting this season between the two sides. Season series tied at one. Tyler Larwood into the attacking zone. His shot goes off of the shoulder of Karpinski. A good save there by the Chicago, Illinois native. Kramer floats it all the way back. Baton Rouge trying to go the other way quickly. Larwood sends it back to Haskins, who has to spin his way away from Roman Kramer here with 15:20 to go in the second period. Man lost an edge, getting rid of the pass. That was Ozelinch as Carolina quickly back in the attacking zone. A big hit there by Haskins on Kramer. Clean hit there as now they go after it into the corner. Jan Salak trying to stand up for his teammate. Haskins, he lost his helmet, makes his way back over. Salak doesn't have a stick as this one's sent back in. This one's starting to pick up a little bit. That'll be on the net. 14:48 to go here in the second period. Carolina leads 3-0. Chirac trying to backhand it out of the zone. Nate Keeley, a nice shot pressuring as Noah Robinson has to go to pick it up. Fires it over far side. Schnapp sends a man into the boards. That's McGuire. Clay Keeley in his own defensive zone. Makes a pass. Goes right through the stick of Chirac as Nate Keeley dumps it in. Takes a ricochet off of the back of the cage. McGuire knocks it along. A bouncing puck at the far dot. Chirac trying to control it. He'll pick it up. Bring it back behind the net. Schnapp finishes off a hit on Chirac over on the far side. Carolina starting to pick it up here. Nate Keeley banks a pass in just to the right of the netminder, Craig Harney. Here with 14:05 to go here in the second period. Shots on goal are 20-6 in favor of the Thunderbirds in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. A quick shot from Noah Robinson's knocked down by Waylon Clay Keeley. Two blue sweaters pressuring him. Finds an escape to Batita. Circles all the way through the middle of his own slot. Almost forgot the puck and makes a pass over to Dawson Baker. Here's Batita trying to center one here, and it's knocked back out to the neutral zone. Now it's a foot race. MJ Graham holding, waiting for reinforcements. Drops it off. Weber, a shot and a save by Karpinski. Squared that one up well. It's one right off of the script Carolina logo across his chest. Baker backhands it over to Gus Ford. Ford goes between the legs of Weber, who goes tumbling down to the ground and plays a stretch pass all the way to Batita. Going one-on-one against Nick Kitsola. He just backhands it in. He goes off for a change. This first line out there for majority of the night last night. As the three go off. 13 minutes to go here in the second period. On the far side, Graham poked away by Jan Salak, comes right back to Michael Civic, gets past Salak, and it's loose at the blue line. Baton Rouge changing, Hippolyte Smith just off of the bench, plays it back to Nick Kitsola, goes cross ice too much on that pass for Civic as Salak right back in. Salak dancing to the outside, dropped it for Kramer. Kramer on the backhand, trying to spin away from Hippolyte Smith. Those two tangle up over into the corner. A hand goes up, a delayed penalty coming up. Who's this going to be against? Looks like it's going to be Roman Kramer going to the box. Here at 12:28 to go here in the second period. Roman Kramer is going to be the first man to the penalty box here this evening, and it brings us to immediate timeout. So 12:28 to go here in the second period. Carolina, 3-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Back after this, this is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Welcome to Martinsville.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. The speed, the shape, the history, the hospitality, heck, even the hot dogs. A one-of-a-kind weekend at the short track of NASCAR with trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday. It's one event too amazing to miss. NASCAR Weekend at Martinsville Speedway. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at riddletractor.com. That's riddletractor.com. Equipping those who get the job done.
Back here in Baton Rouge, Carolina with the 2-0, 3-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Carolina will go to the penalty kill for the first time here tonight as Roman Kramer sent off for 2 minutes. Carolina, the penalty kill for the first time here tonight. Face off to the left of Karpinski's, won by Carolina and clear all the way back out to the neutral zone. Carolina here this season on the penalty kill, 74.4%. On the other side, the power play, 12.2% for the Zydeco here this year. It's a roughing call against Roman Kramer. Matthew Bazarin dispossessed by Yuri Pastuka. Puck ricochets high in the air. MJ Graham can't keep it in. As Bazarin, he picks it up in the neutral zone. He's got Schnapp pressuring. Fires it hard off of the end glass. And over on the far side, Tucker Fur tries to clear. Held in by Haskins. Cross ice to MJ Graham. In the corner, puts the brakes on. He holds at the near half boards. Minute 14 to go on the penalty kill for Carolina. It's Graham. Still has it. Sends it down low to Hansen. Gets a return pass. Where Joe Kennedy clears it all the way down. 1 minute remains on the roughing call against Roman Kramer here with 11:26 to go in period number two. Carolina the 3-0 lead here in this one. Here's Hansen, cross ice to Bazarin. Trying to drop it back, pass goes nowhere. Ford picks it up at the red line, and it'll hold. Clay Keeley up the far side with 30 seconds to go on the penalty kill for Carolina. He dumps this one in after he lost it at his skates. Rattles over near side. It's Weber. Drops it back. Chirac plays it back here at 10:45 to go in the second period. 15 seconds to go on the Roman Kramer roughing call. Carolina leading 3-0 here in this one as Baton Rouge looks for one last opportunity all the way into the attacking zone with Chirac. He lost it into the corner. Him and Salak collide as this one sent all the way back down. Harney will play it. Out of the box is Roman Kramer as Carolina's killed off the penalty. Back to 5-on-5 action here at 10:22 to go in the second period. Salak finishes off a hit of Weber at the red line. Karpinski almost has it taken away. It rattles over near side. Jake Cox picks it up at the near half ports. 1-on-1 against Joe Kennedy. Kramer trying to step in. Salak plays the body against Noah Robinson. Cox goes tumbling to the ground. On the far side, it's Justin Bione. Takes a look at the clock and now brings it across the red line to the backhand. He'll dump this one in as he chases after it over to the far corner. He's the first one there. Salak trying to join him, wins the battle, has it, banks a pass back out to the point. Kennedy, he waits, tries to send one in, goes off of the skates of Jake Cox. It ricochets all the way back out. Sealek gets rid of it quickly. Pass goes off of the stick of Bione as Salak into the attacking zone, takes the puck. Top of the dots, walking to the top of the zone, sends it over to Clay Keeley, far side. 9.5 to go here in the second period. Carolina leading 3-0, a centering pass, and no one was home in a white sweater as it goes harmlessly back out to the neutral zone, and Joe Kennedy controls. Quickly to Roman Kramer, spins away from a man before it's dispossessed right at center ice. Tyler Larwood ahead of steam up the near side. Gets angled off. The hand goes up, though. And it looks like it's going to be another penalty, this time against Joe Kennedy. So Joe Kennedy will go to the box. Here with 9:10 left to go in the second period, they're going to call a slash. So Carolina, who just killed off a penalty, is now going to go to the penalty kill once again. So face off to the right of Karpinski. It's won by Jacob Schnapp. Pastuka zips it over to Schnapp. Now he's 1-on-1. Schnapp trying to dangle in. He'll bring it back out to the neutral zone and reset things here with 8:57 to go in the second period. Carolina leading 3-0. Tucker Firth snaps this one 200 feet. As Carolina's off to a good start here in their second penalty kill of the evening. Already 1-for-1 here tonight. Pass goes cross ice. Hansen at the blue line. Leaves it for Graham. smacks it in. Karpinski drops it off for Tucker Firth. Rattles one off of the glass, went off of Graham, and rather Curtis Hansen, as Graham picks it up back and brings it all the way back towards his netminder. 8:25 to go here in the second period, and a minute 10 remains on the penalty kill for Carolina. Carolina now 100 for 135 on penalty kills here this season. It's Robinson in the attacking zone. Drops it for Hansen. He's got Ford pressure, and Graham has it on the backhand. He's got Ford all over him. Drops it back out to Hansen. Goes far side to Weber. Weber top of the dot. It's a shot. That one didn't get all the way through. One off of Keeley in front. Bione trying to clear the zone, and he does, as him and Robinson got tangled up. 40 seconds to go on the man advantage for Baton Rouge. They're right back in here with 7:48 to go. A centering pass goes through the slot harmlessly. Hansen fires it back over far side. Weber waits. He tried to go cross corner to Hansen and set a nice job by Nate Keeley intercepting, as now Clay Keeley battles for it at the near half boards. Chirac in the corner. Drops it for Jake Cox. Walks out far side. Gets it back out to the point near side. Catola one-timer and a pass save by Karpinski, who checks his near post. Chirac spins at the near dot. Backhands it in front and a save by Karpinski, as he had Robinson right on the doorstep. A backhand attempt from Noah Robinson. Karpinski stands strong in his crease. Some extracurriculars are resolved here. With 7:16 to go here in the second and 6 seconds remaining here on the main advantage for Baton Rouge. Joe Kennedy in the box for slashing. And that will bring us to a media timeout. So 7:16 remains here in period number two. Carolina leading 3-0. Here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco. We're back with more after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Huey to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
Back here in Baton Rouge, about 5 seconds remain on the Joe Kennedy slashing call as Carolina trying to kill this one off here. Shots are 20-10 in our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. Carolina being outshot 6-4 here in the second period. Big part of that, though, is the fact that Baton Rouge has had 2 power plays here in this second period. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. It's going to be a face-off here with 7:16 to go in the second. To the right of Cody Karpinski, just made a point-blank save on Noah Robinson, who has 14 goals here this year. Will be Jan Salak and Matthew Bazarin for the draw. Faceoffs won by Bazarin. Hippolyte Smith plays it back to the point. It's dumped in by Ozalinch. Throw now in front and a save by Karpinski. Hippolyte Smith was right on the doorstep trying to get the quick one-timer. Kennedy out of the box, back to 5-on-5. Cody Karpinski making a couple of huge saves there to keep this a scoreless game. Kramer the other way. His shot is saved by Harney. Karpinski's lived up to everything so far here tonight. 6:54 remains. Salak, a one-timer, and he scores. Jan Salak off of the dot. Gets his 18th goal of the season. A rocket from the top of the slot for Jan as Carolina, they add to their advantage once again. Here with 6:51 to go in the second. It's 4-0 Carolina. Going to look easy here tonight are the Thunderbirds, as we're back underway on the Riddle Tractor goal from Jan Salak. It's right back into the defensive zone for Carolina. John Petito over in the far corner, pinned to the boards by Austin Weber. Yuri Pastuca, he gets an assist. That's his second of the night. He's now sitting at 299 career points. Baker tried to center one before it's knocked down in the slot. Weber from behind his own net drops it off to Nick Kitsola. You're a 6:22 to go in the second period. 4-0, the new advantage for the Thunderbirds. In a big bounce back night here in Baton Rouge. Here's Weber, and they're offside. Weber upset there. But Carolina now leading 4-0 on the rail tractor goal from Jan Salak. Yuri Pastuca and Roman Kramer getting the assist. And now Yuri sitting at 299 points in his FPHL career. He's still got 6:11 to go here in this one. Try to reach the 300 mark. Faceoff across from the Zydeco bench is won by Baton Rouge and dumped in cross corner. Farmer in the corner. Battling, has it knocked away. Nate Keeley trying to leave the zone. Instead, Chirac picks it up, gets past Schnapp at the blue line. He holds, wraps it over to Robinson. His shot is saved by Karpinski. Looked like it went off the knob of his stick and ricocheted into the mesh behind the net. Stuka and Jan Salak, they've been terrific. Remember, no beater Manachik tonight. He had surgery earlier this week. Faceoff is won by Nate Keeley. Clay Keeley gets rid of it. Fires over to Gordon Whalen. Puck bouncing around. Chirac picks it up. Top of the slot. A shot save. The second attempt is knocked away by Karpinski. Still loose in the slot, though. Robinson can't control it, and Nate Keeley fights it back out to the neutral zone. 5.5 to go here in the second period in Baton Rouge up the far side. Chirac thought about a slam shot, gets past Whalen. Shot goes off of the right pad of Karpinski. Robinson gets the rebound, throws it in softly. Karpinski held his near post. Puck still loose, though. Cox gets slammed into the boards by Clay Keeley. A big hit there by Clay Keeley. Cox still not up behind the net. Kitsola trying to get rid of it. Puck bouncing around as now they finally stop it here with 5:09 left to go, but a crunching hit by Clay Keeley. But Jake Cox still on the ground now, just getting back up to his feet. Cox makes his way over the bench. Brings up a face-off to the left to Cody Karpinski, but the physicality has ramped up here in this second period. Clay Keeley with a hard hit here in the near corner. Cox getting tended to by the trainer. Face-off, one back out to the point. Shot doesn't get all the way through in the corner. Salak and Larwood tie up. Kennedy shoves a man off and fires it over near side as we're under 5 minutes to go here in the second period. 2 in the first for Carolina, 2 in the second. Karpinski ends up deflecting that one up into the protective netting here with 4:54 to go here in period number two. At the under five, play continues. Salak wins the draw to the right of Karpinski at the near half boards. Firth chips it along to Salak, goes cross ice to Roman Kramer. Kramer picks it up on the forehand, fires over to Pastuca to Salak in front. Here Salak drops it for Pastuca. Tried to whack it back out. No one is home, though, for the Thunderbirds. Kramer was crashing on the far side. Here comes Baton Rouge the other way. McGuire all the way behind the net. On the forehand, had it go through his legs. Picks it back up, though. McGuire, a quick shot, and that one is saved by Karpinski. It went off the side of the netting. Richardson over to Telstrom. Sent to the ground by Roman Kramer. Pastuca, a quick touch pass to Jan Salak. He dumps this one in. Salak just making it a 4-0 game just a few minutes ago. We approach 4 minutes to go here in the second period. Petito over in the far corner. Throws one off of the skates of Larwood. Baker wraps it back over far side. Petita in the corner. Gets taken down to the ground. His knees. Baker trying to shove it free. Ozalinch is it knocked away. Larwood with Petita on him. Floats it back out. Ford applies a hit there on Larwood, and it comes back out to James Farmer. Farmer quickly the other way to Ford. His pass gets to Batita. They're onside. Batita near dot drops it for Ford. Right back to Batita into the corner. 3:35 to go here in the second period, which is brought to you by Flow Automotive. Carolina 4, Baton Rouge nothing. Weber up the near side. Runs into Gus Ford of the Raising Cane's River Center logo at center ice. Play back out, a bank pass. Did Graham get a piece of it? He did, as Bione chases after it. Just from beside his own net, plays a stretch pass up to Batita, chips it back to Ford. Ford, top of the slot. His shot gets deflected off of Haskins out of play. Here with 3:05 to go in the second period. And that brings us to immediate timeout. 3:05 to go here in period number two. Jan Salak and Yuri Pastuka, two goals here in this period as Carolina had 4-0 with 3:05 to go here in the second. We're back to the Raising Cane's River Center after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
4-0, Carolina in front here, 3:05 to go here in period number two. Shots are 22-15, our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker. Yuri Pastuka sitting on 299 career points now in his FPHL career after he's gotten a goal and an assist here tonight. He's now got goal number 123 and assist 176. He's got a pair of points in now each of the games he's played here against the Zydeco this season. A faceoff comes to the right of Greg Harney, who here tonight has saved 18 out of 22 shots. Cody Karpinski has saved all 15. He's see a quick shot off of the restart from Schnapps, gloved by Harney. There's only 3 seconds trickled off of the clock. That brings up another faceoff to the right of Harney. Faceoff. Chip back out to the blue line. Kennedy, or rather Clay Keeley, got rid of it. He went tumbling to the ground. He keeps it in at the near point. Keeley finds Nate Keeley trying to dance through. A nice shot by McGuire. This is the last man there. Schnapp deposits a man into the boards. He got rid of Haskins over in the near corner. It's right back to Keeley, shoved into the boards by Chirac. Schnapp chips it along. Haskins wanted a little retaliation. Didn't have an opportunity. Sealek behind the net, trying to dance out to the forehand. Gets pinned by McGuire. Leaves it for Nate Keeley as he gets tangled up there with Chirac. Chirac taking his legs out. Clay Keeley keeps it in at the blue line, trying to fire it in, but it's taken away by Haskins. Drops it off near side. Sealek applies the body in, angles off Jake Cox. Here with 2:13 to go here in the second period. Carolina 4 and Baton Rouge nothing. Whalen dumps this one in into the corner. Now at the near half boards, Kramer trying to poke it free. Said it's played off of the end boards. Here's a chance Kramer has in the slot over Pastuka, and his one-timer gets deflected and flutters wide. He picks it up, though, first at the half-boards. Backhands it over to Salak at the near dot. Salak spins his way back out, surveying. He holds at the near half-boards, has some space, trying to center one into Roman Kramer. Went off the skate, though, of Thomas McGuire, who clears the zone, but only right to Gordon Whalen, who rattles it all the way back in here with 1:38 to go here in the second period. Salak out body Chirac. Kramer banks a pass back out to Firth. Chipped along by Salak before it's rattled all the way back out. This one went out of play. Did it take a deflection or did it go off of the boards? Carolina wants to delay a game. And it looks like they're going to get it. So Carolina is going to go to their first Little Italy power play of the evening. Scott Chirac is called for a delay of game here with 1:23 to go here in the second period. Carolina gets their first crank at the power play here tonight. Carolina on the power play this season, working at a 23% clip. They get the first unit out there, and Yuri Pastuka controls off of the draw. Sends it to Roman Kramer at the near half boards. Behind the net to Gus Ford. Ford. Saucers at far side. It's Baker back out to Basuka as they go around the horn. Baker, far dot, fires it over to Kramer. Too much on that one. As it ricochets high in the air in the middle of the slot. Hansen waited and fires it up to Larwood. Under a minute to go here in the second period. 2-1 opportunity on the short end. A quick shot and a glove save by Karpinski. Larwood. And his pass taken away by Pastuka, who went all the way down to the ground. He tried to beat Karpinski near side. Kramer back in the attacking zone. Over to Ford. Far corner. Fires it back out. Baker settles. Pastuka, quick touch to Kramer. His shot saved by Horney. Right back to Kramer. He has it again. Kramer waits. Sends it back out top of the zone. Pastuka, Kramer, far side. Here's Baker. A shot. And that one is to get all the way through. Battling for it over in the far corner. Baker goes to the ground as this one's cleared all the way down with 15 seconds to go here in the second period. It's lost behind the net. Here's a chance, and they score. And they wave it off. They say Karpinski was interfered with. Karpinski out from behind his net, got taken down. Richardson picked it up with Karpinski down behind the net. He scored. They wave it off, and now they're going to send Richardson to the penalty box. Here in Baton Rouge don't like the call, but now Carolina is going to have a 5-on-3 opportunity. So they call interference. Now pucks are coming down onto the ice. Still coming down, and there's Chuck-a-puck coming up here in the second intermission. But fans unhappy with the call, and instead it's going to be 5-on-3. 44 seconds remain on the original penalty, which was a delay of game against Scott Chirac. Bradley Richardson just called for interference. Goal waved off, and so it remains a 4-0 game. Karpinski taken out behind the net. Everett Thompson, that coach for Baton Rouge, not happy there behind his net. Slams the glass behind the bench. But so now 5-on-3. Here with 7.6 seconds left to go here in the second period. And Carolina now with the 2-man advantage. Petito for the draw. It's one back. A quick one-timer from Schnapp goes off of the legs of Ozilinch into the corner. Thrown back in front, a quick shot, and that one sails off the side of the netting from Tucker Firth, and that does it for period number two. A chorus of boos from the Zydeco faithful here at the end of the second period, which finds the Carolina Thunderbirds leading the Baton Rouge Zydeco by a score of 4-0 after 40 minutes here at the Raising Cane's River Center. In that second period, Yuri Pastuka and Jan Salak, they get the two goals, and Carolina is going to take 38 seconds of 5-on-3 into the third period. And then they will have about a minute 16 of a regular 5-on-4 power play. But Carolina have a 4-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco through 40 minutes of action here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina with a good bounce back so far through 40 minutes. They try to finish this one off in the final 20, which is coming up here in just a little bit. The Little Italy second intermission report's coming up next. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
When it comes to performance, speed matters. Just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry.
With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry. We're taking...
Welcome to Martinsville.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. The speed, the shape, the history, the hospitality, heck, even the hot dogs. A one-of-a-kind weekend at the short track of NASCAR with trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday. It's one event too amazing to miss. NASCAR weekend at Martinsville Speedway. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
Graybrook Technologies is located in downtown Winston-Salem near the Dash Stadium. We specialize in automation, integration, and motor control with our team of dedicated engineers, a UL industrial control panel shop, and our warehouse packed with VFDs and components to fabricate the custom controls your company needs. Graybrook is a preferred partner with Danfoss, Siemens, Schneider Square D, and others, to bring your project to life with brands you know and trust. Visit our website at graybrook.com or call us at 336-310-9092 to learn more about the array of services we offer.
Let's go Birds!
Back here in Baton Rouge, and it's the Thunderbirds who have a 4-0 lead after the first 40 minutes of action here on a Friday evening at the Raising Cane's River Center. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, back in our WTOB studios as Carolina, they led 2-0 after the first, and now they lead 4-0 after the second here in this one. How do we get there? Going to the first period at the 9:40 mark. Dawson Baker setting his new career high in a single season for goals, getting his 21st on a shot from Gus Ford that ricocheted off of the end glass and came right back out in front for Dawson Baker, who found the back of the net to give Carolina the 1-0 lead. Tucker Firth getting an assist as well. Carolina led 1-0 there at the 9:40 mark, and then at the 14:17 mark there in the first period, Gus Ford threw it in from the blue line intentionally wide. John Batita played it right out in front for Clay Keeley, who found the back of the net, a wide open net for his second goal this season, and gave Carolina the 2-0 advantage there in that one. They held that lead going to the second period. Carolina outshot Baton Rouge 16-4 in that first 20 minutes of action. Then in the second period, brought to you by Flow Automotive. Just a minute 14 in, Carolina with a quick breakout. James Farmer finding Roman Kramer, who's in 2-on-1 with Yuri Pastuca. Back in and one to Pastuca, who finished off his 13th goal of the season. He's got a goal now in each of his last three games. That was also his 298th career FBHL point in the regular season. Farmer and Roman Kramer get an assist at the 1:14 mark to make it 3-0. And then off of a face-off draw, Roman Kramer getting his second assist of the night. Yuri Pastuca getting his second point of the night as he found Jan Salak free in the top of the slot and fired one high over the shoulder of Greg Harney to make it a 4-0 game at the 13:09 mark, and that is where we sit right now here in this one, with Carolina leading the Baton Rouge Zydeco by a score of 4-0. No penalties in the first period. In the second, though, Kramer was called for a roughing call at the 7:32 mark. Carolina killed that one off. Joe Kennedy was called for a slashing call at the 10:50. Carolina killed it off once again. They're 2-for-2 on the penalty kill here tonight. Scott Shirock at the 18:37 mark was called for a delay of game that put Carolina on their first power play of the evening. And then with 7 seconds left to go, it was a goalie interference as Cody Karpinski went out from his crease to play the puck behind the net. He was run into by Bradley Richardson, who ended up scoring. They waved the goal off, and it ends up putting Richardson in the box instead of a shorthanded goal. And so Carolina still with a 4-0 lead, and they're at 5-on-3 for the first 37 seconds coming out of the second intermission here in this one. A couple pucks made their way prematurely for Chuck-a-Puck onto the ice there at the end of the second period, as now Chuck-a-Puck commences here at the Raising Cane's River Center, in which the Thunderbirds have a 4-0 lead over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Carolina and Baton Rouge tied at 13 on the shots on goal department there in that second period, with Carolina leading 29-17. Our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker, Greg Hardy, has saved 25 out of 29 shots here tonight. On the other side for Baton Rouge, rather, for Cody Karpinski, he has saved all 17 shots he's seen here this evening. So Carolina here at the second intermission lead the Baton Rouge Zydeco by a score of 4-0 here in this one, as we're at the second intermission report, which is brought to you by Little Italy Pizza, an Italian restaurant in Rural Hall. 4-0, Carolina in front here in this one. Here at the second intermission, we'll take a look around the rest of the FPHL, update you on the games in action, some finals as well. So we got more to come here in the second intermission report after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Get ready, Winston-Salem. Jennifer Sapp, your trusted realtor and broker since 1997, puts the real in realtor, and she's proud to be a sponsor of your Carolina Thunderbirds. As a top producer and your go-to realtor for all your real estate needs, Jennifer Sapp is ready to help you score your dream home goal. Call Jennifer at 336-782-3148 or visit her at jennifersapp.allenton.com.
The Flow Garage app helps you keep up with your vehicles from anywhere. Flow customers can request service appointments, receive text and video updates, view sales and service history, receive recall notifications, and even get purchase offers via Flow Offer to Purchase. Download the app today.
Back here at the Raising Cane's River Center, it's the Thunderbirds who hold a 4-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco after the first 40 minutes of action. About 10:43 remains until the start of period number three, and we take a trip around the rest of the FPHL here this evening. We start with the games in action right now. We will start with one that's in overtime up at the Danbury Arena. Danbury and Port Huron, and a wild one from Connecticut. A game that was tied with 3 seconds left by Matt Graham on it with a 6-on-5 opportunity. Danbury, they led 5-3 going into the final nearly 2 minutes there in that one before Tucker Scantleberry made it a one-goal game at the 17:58 mark there. Matt Graham getting an assist, and then Graham tied it up there at the 19:57 mark with only 3 seconds remaining. 5-5 in overtime there in that one. A game that's seen a few unsportsmanlike conducts and more there between Danbury and Port Huron. Another game in action right now. The FPHL's from Biloxi in Mississippi. And Columbus is going to pick up another victory here this evening. They lead the Mississippi Seawolves by a score of 7-1 with about 2.5 minutes to go in the third period. There in that one, they led 4-0 after one. They led 5-1 after two, and now lead 7-1 there against the Mississippi Seawolves. They scored the first four. Joaquin Nielsen made it a 4-1 game just over 7 minutes into the second. And since then, Justin McDonald, Hunter Bersani, and Ryan Hunter finding the back of the net. And it's 7-1 in favor of Columbus there in that one. There at the Mississippi Coast Coliseum, they got 2 minutes to go. Carolina will see Columbus in a week's time down at the Columbus Civic Center in Columbus, Georgia. They got 2 minutes to go there in that one. Blue Ridge in Motor City, they were in a good one. They went to overtime, and they went to a shootout. Ended up Motor City taking away the 3-2 shootout victory, winning the shootout 1-0 there in that one. It was a 2-0 Motor City lead before Cody Oaks and Nikita Ivashkin were able to tie it up. They went to overtime. They went to the shootout. And Motor City is able to win it there to take down Blue Ridge by a score of 3-2, 1-0, the shutout there. Blue Ridge out shooting Motor City 39-34. And it was TJ Sneath, the decider, in the fourth round of the shootout. That game only had two penalties across all 65-plus minutes there in that one. And then the one other game here tonight, it went final during our first intermission report. It was Elmira picking up a 6-3 win over the Binghamton Black Bears. Dominic Dubas named first star of the evening there in that one after he got a goal and an assist. That's a look around the rest of the FPHL here this evening in ours. It's 4-0 in favor of Carolina. This one got underway about 25 minutes late here in this one. A late already back in Winston-Salem, about 10:40. Local time, 9:39 down here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Don't forget, coming up tomorrow, game 3 of this series starting at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 o'clock local time. Pre-game coverage will start 30 minutes before puck drop here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. The second intermission report, which is brought to you by Little Italy Pizza, continues on the other side of this timeout. Carolina 4, Baton Rouge nothing. Back after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day, and when we go on adventures, we get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flow Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Martinsville isn't your average everyday racetrack. Far from it. It's truly one of a kind. With trucks on Friday, Xfinity on Saturday, and Cup Series on Sunday, it's one event too amazing to miss. Get your tickets now at martinsvillespeedway.com.
When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry.
Hey, Thunderbirds, are you looking for a metal building?
Here at Bulldog Steel Structures, we got you covered with multiple garages, barns, and styles you need.
Contact us today to get your free quote at 888-551-2156.
Or visit our website, www.bulldogsteelstructures.com, and mention the Thunderbirds, and we'll give you a flying deal. God bless you.
Go Thunderbirds!
Back here at the Raising Cane's River Center, and the Thunderbirds responding here tonight with a 4-0 lead over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Last Friday, an 8-0 shutout victory for the second of the year for the Thunderbirds. Last night, a 5-3 loss here in Baton Rouge. And tonight, Carolina back on track with a 4-0 lead. They will start period number 3. On a 5-on-3 for about the first 38 seconds, and then it will be About a minute 14 of a power play for Carolina after Scott Chirac was called for a delay of game at the 18:37 mark there in the second period, and Bradley Richardson was called for a interference that ended up taking a goal off the board. Ended up putting him in the penalty box, and Carolina will have 5-on-3 for the first 37-38 seconds here of the third period. Dawson Baker setting a new career high for goals with 21 with his first of the night at the 9:40 mark in the first period. Clay Keeley getting his second FBHL goal of his career, made it 2-0. Carolina held that lead after 20 minutes, and in the second period, Yuri Pastuka ended up getting point number 298 of his FBHL career at the 1:14 mark on a 2-on-1 opportunity, make it 3-0. He then got point 299 on an assist and a one-timer for Jan Salak at the top of the slot as Carolina, they lead 4-0 after 40 minutes. Here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco, Cody Karpinski has saved all 17 shots he's seen. On the other side, Greg Harney has allowed 4 goals on 29 shots here this evening. Carolina trying to finish this one off here tonight. Trying to be able to pick up a 3 points, eclipse the 80-point mark. Trying to close in on a playoff spot. Binghamton and Columbus have already clinched. Carolina are close here tonight. Carolina trying to pull this one out here this evening and try to be able to come away with the victory here tonight. They were the Baton Rouge Zydeco here in this one. Carolina leading here at the second intermission by a score of 4-0. We're back for the start of period number 3 on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action. When it comes to performance, speed matters, just like on the ice. Introducing same-day dental crowns right here at Twin Oaks Dentistry. With cutting-edge technology, we craft crowns on-site, eliminating the need for temporary. As proud sponsors of the Carolina Thunderbirds, we understand the need for top-notch performance. We're more than just dental care. We're your partners in achieving your best smile. Twin Oaks Dentistry, where technology.
Here at ComTech, we think it shouldn't cost a fortune to have peace of mind. That's why we bring you the latest in smart home protection and home monitoring at prices you can afford. Already paying for home monitoring? We can beat it. Give us a call today or visit us at ctpower.com. That's ctpower.com. ComTech, your one stop for security, fire, cameras, and more.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
We're back here in Baton Rouge, getting ready for the start of the third period here this evening, which is brought to you by Mustin and Crutchfield. Carolina with the 4-0 lead here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco after the first 40 minutes of action, as now they look to try to close this one out here this evening. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. Great to have you along here tonight. It's been all Thunderbirds across the first 40 minutes of action. They'll start on 5-on-3 here in this Mustin and Crutchfield third period as they wait for the officials who are now making their way out onto the ice. Officials make their way out, followed by Cody Karpinski and the Thunderbirds as we are getting just about set for the start of the third period. It'll be 37 seconds of 5-on-3 for Carolina. here in this third period. And the Thunderbirds here tonight, they have been great so far. Dawson Baker got the scoring started. Clay Keeley got the second. Yuri Pastuga the third. And Jan Salak the fourth. As the Thunderbirds, they have the advantage. Trying to close this one out here tonight. For Cody Karpinski, he saved all 17 shots he's seen here this evening. On the other side, Greg Harney has saved 25 out of 29 here tonight. It'll be Chirac in the box as well as Bradley Richardson. As the Zydeco have made their way back out onto the ice. And Carolina is going to try to put an early nail in the coffin here in this one with the extra man advantage, the two that is. We'll start. Here tonight as they announce a franchise record for attendance here tonight. Haven't had hockey in nearly 2 months here as they announced an attendance of 5,503 here this evening. Here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina spoiling that right now though. Trying to finish it off. They start with Petita, Schnapp, Firth, as well as Clay Keeley. And Chris Selick to get things started here in our Mustin and Crutchfield third period. 5-on-3 to start things off for the Thunderbirds. And they're right into the attacking zone off of the draw. Jacob Schnapp sets up. Man lost an edge in Baton Rouge. Fired over far side. Clay Keeley, he holds. Sends it back to Tucker Firth. Top of the slot. The lefty waits. Finds the other lefty. Here's a one-timer. A shot and a save by Horney. Behind the net, Selick picks it up. Here 20 seconds into the third. Clay Keeley. Down to John Petita. Petita trying to get past Haskins, throws him right off of Harney, and this one's clear. 7 seconds to go until 5-on-4 action, and then it'll be about a minute 15 on the power play for Carolina here. Once again, leading 4-0 out of the box is Chirac, 5-on-4 for the next minute 13. 5-on-4. Dawson Baker fires it quickly over to Roman Kramer. He has to take it all the way back out to the neutral zone. At center ice, Kramer ahead of steam into the attacking zone. Settles on the forehand, fires it out to Ford, and is knocked away by Chirac, and Jake Cox will send it all the way down just to the left of Cody Karpinski. Just over a minute into our Mustard and Crutchfield third period. Carolina 4, Baton Rouge nothing here on the power play. 0-for-1 here tonight. Ford chasing after it, but it's taken away by McGuire. Tries to get one past Yuri Pastuca. He can't. Over in the corner, Pastuca picks it up. This is the first unit out there for Carolina here on the power play. Pastuca backhands over to Ford. 30 seconds to go on the man advantage. Kramer far side. Centers one to Baker and a save by Harney. Baker was looking for a second here tonight. Harney denies him. Going post to post and sprawling down. Here come the Thunderbirds once again right back in. 17 seconds left to go on the power play. Ford dancing in front and a save by Harney. Larwood in the corner. Trying to clear. Kramer knocks it down. Baker sends it back in. Katola intercepts though and fires it up to Hansen, who's now 2-on-0. Hansen over to Larwood. His shot goes wide. Richardson out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5 here. 2 minutes into the third period. This one thrown off of the back of the cage. Salak over to Gus Ford. Good chances over those first 2 minutes for both sides. Too heavy of a touch there for Bione, who shoves Haskins. Back shrinking is Ozilinch. It's lost at the blue line. Man goes tumbling to the ground. Salak picks it up before Larwood takes it away. Larwood right down Broadway. As it chipped away, he turns and fires and sends one into the protective netting here with 17:32 to go in the third. And now they are sending Jacob Schnapp to the box for 2 minutes for tripping. And so Carolina will go to the penalty kill for the third time this evening. Baton Rouge 0-for-2 on the power play here tonight. this season. They are now 20 for 166. Carolina on the penalty kill. Coming in tonight at 74.4%. Now 101 for 136. Power play underway. And it starts with Carolina going the other way after a defensive zone faceoff win. Kennedy, one on three. He just dumps this one in. So Schnapp for 2 minutes for tripping. That now ties him for the most penalty minutes in Carolina Thunderbirds history. Up the far side, Jake Cox into the attacking zone as it chipped away. Gets it back, though, circling, holds near side. Throws it back out to Nick Katol at the blue line. Can't find an angle. Here's Cox. He winds and fires. It goes off of Firth. It goes tumbling to the ground. It's knocked behind the net. Kennedy trying to take it away. Dances through a man. He'll flip it all the way down. Minute 15 to go here on the penalty kill for Carolina. 16:45 to go here in the Mustin and Crutchfield third period. It's Katol up the far side. Drops it off. Cox, his shot taken away by Jan Salak. In the far corner, it's played back out to the point. A walking shot from Robinson. Saved by Karpinski. Easy save there for Karpinski, who saw it the whole way. Not a lot of traffic in front. So 16:31 remains here in the third period. Carolina leads 4-0 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. A minute left to go here on the man advantage for the home side. The faceoff comes all the way back out in front of Baton Rouge's bench. It's MJ Graham going all the way back. Behind is netminder Greg Harney, who tonight has saved 27 out of 31 shots. On the other side, Cody Karpinski has saved 18. Haskins into the attacking zone ahead of steam. He throws one that's parried away by Karpinski. Bazarin throws one back out in front. Karpinski held his near post, and it's cleared all the way back out to Curtis Hansen. 30 seconds remain here on the penalty kill for Carolina. Jacob Schnapp in the box for slashing. Telstrom at the top of the zone. Flutters one to Graham. Back out to Haskins. His shot goes wide. It went off of Nate Keeley. Clay Keeley battling for it. Shoves Bazarin into the boards, but it's held by MJ Graham at the near half boards. Cycling in, he holds. Spins away, brings it back out. Puts the brakes on. Looking for a pass, can't find anything. 4 seconds to go on the power play. His shot deflected over into the corner. Out of the box, Jacob Schnapp back to 5-on-5 action. Bouncing puck. James Farmer plays a pass to himself off the corner board. Still has it and waits and finds Jan Salak with 15:20 to go here in the third period. Back to 5-on-5 action. Carolina 4 and Baton Rouge nothing here in the second of 3 here this week. A puck bounces back out in front. Schnapp lifts the stick of Haskins. He has it waiting. Fires it over to Salak. Top of the slot. Kicks it to himself. A quick shot flutters in. And it's saved by Harney. Here with 15:05 left to go in the third. Baker and Haskins and James some pleasantries. Brings up an attacking zone face-off draw. First line out there of forwards for Carolina. As well as Gordon Whalen and Justin Bione. Face-offs won by Ford. Played near side Bione. His shot zips wide on the far side. Whalen picks it up at the far point. Settles it down here with just over 5 minutes gone here in the third period. Ford in the corner. Pokes it past Hippolyte Smith. It's fought over near side. Richardson trying to back in and out. Instead, Ford has it. His shot goes off of Katola. Ricochets over into the near corner. Petita finishes off a hit on Richardson. It comes all the way back down on Karpinski. Plays it off the far half. Ford's Larwood gets it poked away. And it's sent back out all the way into the attacking zone for Carolina. Katola plays it past Petita, who drops it for Larwood. Here with 14:25 to go in the third period. Larwood to the outside, sends one cross ice, too much on that one, as it was just out in front of Jake Cox. A pass from Kennedy is almost intercepted. Firth reached out the right hand with the stick to knock it along. Kennedy holds behind his own net. Here at Carolina leading 4-0, shots 32-20 on our Comtech LLC shots on goal tracker in favor of the Thunderbirds. Firth drops a pass back to Joe Kennedy in front of his own bench. Got to the red line, threw it off of the back of Gus Ford. McGuire up to Noah Robinson. Angled off by Tucker Firth. Firth holding his face. Looked like he thought he got hit high. No call, though, from either of the referees. Here's a quick shot and a save by Karpinski. Rebound attempt sent through the crease. Noah's home, though. McGuire stepping up from the point, pinching down into the corner. Centers one, trying to find Jake Cox instead. Civic rattles it in. Cox goes down over in the far corner. Kennedy sent him to the ground. The hand goes up and a delayed penalty, and now a penalty coming up against Joe Kennedy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, is it time of night for the announcement for the Booster Club raffle?
So please, Kennedy's going to go to the box. They're at 13:22 remaining here in the third period.
The winning ticket number is 5-7-2-2-4-8.
And that'll bring us to a media timeout. So Joe Kennedy to the box. When we come back, Carolina leading the Baton Rouge Zydeco 4-0 here in the third. Here on a Friday night at the Raising Cane's River Center. We're back with more after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Team 22 remains here in the third period. Carolina with a 4-0 lead, but they'll be going to the penalty kill for the fourth time here this evening. Joe Kennedy called for a boarding minor. And now has the Thunderbirds on the penalty kill. They're already 3-for-3 on the PK here tonight. They wait for the media timeout to expire. And it'll be a face-off to the left of Cody Karpinski.
All right, fans, we got 5. They got 4. That means we're on a red stick adventure.
Schnott for the draw. And it's one back to the point, though, to Haskins. In the neutral zone now. Haskins with Schnott pressuring him. Plays it to the outside. Bazzer in a quick touch. Farmer and Schnapp take down Haskins. It's backhanded along. Pastuca clears the zone as it's picked up by Curtis Hansen. Hansen at center ice sends it near side in front of the penalty boxes to Matthias Tellstrom, who finds Bazarin trying to float it along. Sends it cross ice. It flutters through at the top of the zone. Bione coming in to try to finish off a hit. It's loose at the far point. Nate Keeley, rather Yuri Pastuca, battling for it. Tellstrom takes it. Waits for the Zydeco to get back on the side. Telstrom at the blue line. Backhands it over far side. A quick centering pass. Bazarin couldn't hang on to it. Pastuca plays it off of the boards. Clubbed down by MJ Graham, though. Graham walking the blue line. Fires it over far side. Weber spinning away from Bione. Got sent to the ground. Gets back to his feet. Backhands it out to the point. Hansen, a shot deflected in front by Telstrom. Goes wide on the near side. Bazarin picks up the loose puck. Got Pastuca on him, spins a shot, and that one just goes past the far post. Weber behind the cage. Back to Hansen, near dot, waiting. Fires it over far side. Graham trying to settle down a loose puck, and Bione takes it away. Bione gets to the blue line and dumps it all the way down as Carolina clears here with 30 seconds remaining on the boarding call against Joe Kennedy and 11:50 to go here in the third period. Carolina with the 4-0 lead here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco in the second of three here this weekend. Chirac trying to dump it in. Doesn't get all the way through, and it's taken away by Nate Keeley. He's got Jan Salak joining late. Keeley loses the puck. Nick Katola picks it up and puts the brakes on behind his cage with 8 seconds left to go here on the man advantage. Kennedy getting ready to come out of the box. Chirac in front of the Thunderbirds bench dances past Clay Keeley and all the way down to the far corner where Tucker Firth angles him off, and it's lifted all the way back down on the netminder Hardy, who will have to cover with Joe Kennedy pressuring him. So Carolina now 4-for-4 tonight on the penalty kill. They look good pretty much in every facet here tonight. A Good response and a good bounce back after the past two nights for this Thunderbirds team. Face off to the left of Horney. It's won by Jake Cox into the corner. Katola tries to chip it along. Batita applies a check on McGuire. Ford takes it in the near corner. Sends it back out to the point. A shot from Whalen goes off a Chirac. Ricochets over far side. Heggie will try to cycle it back in. Batita left it for Dawson Baker. Baker out to Ford at the half boards. He throws it off of the end boards. Batita picks it up, holding on the forehand, fires it back out to the point. A shot from Whalen goes intentionally wide, takes a ricochet off of the end boards. Ford chips it along to Baker. Baker waiting, back out to the point, gets a return pass. Baker trying to find it back out to Whalen, went off of Robinson's stick, but Whalen dumps it into the corner again. Over at the near half boards, Baker down to Batita, will cycle it back along. Ford chasing after. McGuire applies a good check on him into the corner boards. A lot of zone time here for the Thunderbirds here tonight. We got 10:20 to go here in the third period, but Carolina leading 4-0. Ford takes it away, fires it over to Whalen, top of the dot. His shot goes wide. He was trying to find Petito over on the far side. Baton Rouge still can't clear. Ford waiting at the near dot. Run into by Scott Chirac. Batita's pass goes cross ice and goes all the way back down as Baton Rouge desperately gets off for a change after Carolina had about a minute in the attacking zone there. Couldn't come away with a goal, though. We're past the midway point here in period number three. 4-0, Carolina, the advantage, trying to secure the 3 points here tonight. Heggie from behind his own net. His pass intercepted by Hippolyte Smith. Here's Larwood dancing in. Backhands it over to Richardson, who couldn't control it. A turnover in the defensive zone almost ended up in a goal for Baton Rouge, but they're not able to finish. And offside is called as the Thunderbirds and Nick Keeley tried to bank a pass. They got it just a half second too early, and that brings us to another media timeout. 9:23 remains here in the third period. Carolina with the 4-0 advantage here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco, trying to close this one out here tonight. We'll take a timeout, come back with more on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. This is Thunderbirds Hockey. Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill, relax by our pool and cabana, and gear up at the Pro Shop while sharpening your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. You can find out more at MapleChaseCC.com. That's MapleChaseCC.com. Back in Baton Rouge, it's a 4-0 lead for Carolina here with the Baton Rouge Zydeco at 9:23 to go here in period number three. Brendan Riley with you here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. It's been a controlled effort from Carolina here tonight. They're trying to finish this one off here this evening. Face off across from Baton Rouge's bench. Graham and Nate Keeley for the draw, and Nate ends up winning it, and Joe Kennedy smacks it all the way around. The near corner, Schnapp disposes of Haskins, but the hand went up. And that will send Jacob Schnapp to the penalty box once again. Here at 9:13 to go, here in the third period, Jacob Schnapp will go to the box for the second time here tonight. And with that, Jacob Schnapp now has the most penalty minutes in Carolina Thunderbirds history with 399. So Carolina back to the penalty kill. It's held in. Here's a shot from Katola. It deflects wide. Behind the net, they battle for it. Kennedy knocks it away. And it comes all the way back out to the neutral zone, all the way back down on the netminder, Harney. 8:55 to go here in the third period, and a minute 40 to go on the two-minute call against Jacob Schnapp. On the far side, it's Chirac. Plays it off of the boards. Kennedy takes it. He waits and snaps it down 200 feet. So they called a boarding call. That's now the second boarding call in a row against Carolina. Thunderbirds 4-for-4 on the penalty kill here tonight. The far side, Chirac into the far corner, fires it back out to the point. Cross ice, Weber walking in. A shot saved by Karpinski, and Clay Keeley gets rid of the rebound. Karpinski saw that one the whole way. And his defense able to pick him up and get rid of it. Baton Rouge onside, but the pass goes off of the skate of a blue sweater and comes all the way back out to the neutral zone where MJ Graham collects. 7:55 to go here in the third period. 4-0, Carolina in front. Clay Keeley tries to smack this one out of the zone, and it takes a ricochet off of a stanchion all the way back out. 30 seconds to go here on the Jacob Schnapp boarding call. MJ Graham trying to get this one in deep. Instead, Bione gloves it down and sends it right back out. Matthias Telstrom takes it away. He's shouldered off by Bione. And Salak sends it back to the attacking blue line for Carolina. 12 seconds to go on the man advantage for Baton Rouge. Salak trying to clear. It's held in at the point by Graham. Thought about a slap shot. Instead, will circle. Hold at the point. Finds Hansen near side. Fires it over into the near corner. Snap out of the box. Back to 5-on-5. Behind the net, Telstrom against Batita. Angled off by John Batita. Clay Keeley finds Jacob Schnapp. We were 7 minutes to go in the third period. Schnapp trying to dangle through. Has it in front on the back end. It goes off the bar, off the back of Harney and in. Jacob Schnapp gets his 16th goal of the season. A new career high for the Florida native Jacob Schnapp. Just like he did all the way back in Binghamton. Dangles through the defense. Gets some help from the crossbar on the backside of Greg Harney. And Carolina here with 6:53 to go in the third period have a 5-0 lead. An unassisted Riddle tractor goal for Jacob Schnapp, who's now got a goal in each of his last three games. 5-0, your new score. Here with 6.5 minutes to go in the third period. Carolina with a response here tonight, and they're looking for more. It's Batita. Puts the blinders on top of the dots. He fires one off of the skates of McGuire. Dawson Baker finishing off a hit on Bradley Richardson as Firth backtracks to pick it up. Hippolyt Smith pressuring him. Firth banks a pass back out to the neutral zone. All McGuire can do is send it back in as Baton Rouge had to get back onside. Whalen with Larwood pressuring. Finds Firth on the near side. 6 minutes to go here in the third. Dawson Baker with Ford gets his stick lifted. Goes into the corner. Delayed penalty coming up against Baton Rouge. Carolina will be going to the power play here with just a little bit. The hand remains up. Karpinski to the bench as Carolina gets the extra attacker out there. Salak into the attacking zone. Pinned up at the half boards. Here with 5:36 to go. Carolina will go to their third power play here this evening. They're going to get Haskins for a hook. So now Carolina a chance to add to their 5-0 advantage as they go to a Little Italy power play. Oza Lynch talking with Jake Herzog. He makes his way back towards the dot. It'll be a face-off to the left of Harney. First unit out there for Carolina. Kramer, Ford, Salak, Yuri Pastuka, Dawson Baker. Face-off is won by the Thunderbirds. Far side, Ford, top of the dots. Fires it over to Pastuca, finds Baker near side, right back. Here's Kramer, far side, the lefty waits, finds Ford behind the net. He holds, brings it near side, floats it back out to Pastuca, top of the slot. Larwood went down to a knee, closed off the angle, Ford behind the net now. Once again, setting things up. Tried to find Salak, it's knocked away, brought back out to Baker. So we approach 5 minutes to go, a minute 29 remains on the power play for Carolina. Here's Salak, top of the slot, trying to settle it down. Instead, Larwood goes the other way, and he'll spin his way back here with 4:55 to go in the third period. A minute 18 remains on the power play for Carolina, which is brought to you by Little Italy. Carolina 0 for 2 tonight. They had a 5-on-3 opportunity. Kramer over to Farmer. Farmer has it taken away by Jake Cox. A bouncing puck skips past Schnapp, and it's picked up by Noah Robinson. Robinson can't get past Firth as Karpinski fires it out to Schnapp, who sends it over far side. 4.5 to go, 50 to go on the man advantage for Carolina. A stretch pass to Chris Sielek, who was just signed earlier this week. Kramer out to the point. Firth thought about the slap shot. He waits. Goes D to D to James Farmer. Farmer settles it. Here's on the far side, Roman Kramer. Back out to Farmer. He gets it right back. Walking in. Far dot. His shot goes off of a skate. Schnapp battling in the slot. Battling for it. Sielek, Katola. And Kramer will chase after it into the corner. Kramer on the forehand. Back out to Farmer. Farmer walking the blue line. You're 20 seconds to go on the power play. Firth cycles back, keeps it in, waiting. Sends it over to Sielek. Finds Schnapp trying to walk through. Instead, it's poked away, and it's cleared all the way down. And that will do it for the power play opportunity for Carolina. Haskins out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 here at 3:33 to go in the third. Carolina with the 5-0 lead. Getting ready to close out victory. Number 29 here this season. Nate Keeley dances all the way behind the cage. Waiting on the forehand. He tried to fire it over to Batita. The pass went off a skate. Ozilinch battling the corner. Batita knocks it free. Can't get past Ozilinch. Puck bouncing around. Curtis Heggie steps up, but Larwood intercepts and fires it out far side to Curtis Hansen. Hansen across the blue line. They're onside, trying to go with a toe drag. Whalen angles him off behind the net. Finishes off a check behind the cage. Graham and Nate Keeley battle. Nate Keeley fires it over to Heggie, who tries to clear the zone. It's held in for a second by McGuire. McGuire can't keep it in. 2:45 to go here in the third. MJ Graham back into the attacking zone up the far side. Whalen poke checks him behind the net. Kennedy in the near corner, run off by a blue sweater. Four guys tangle up as a man goes tumbling down to the ground. Kennedy takes the puck away as slowly getting back to his feet was MJ Graham. Nate Keeley picks it up here with 2:20 to go in the third. Carolina with the 5-0 lead here over Baton Rouge. Baker will dump this one in. Haskins had it go off of his hand. It's picked up behind the net by Michael Civic. Plays a pass far side. Sielek spins a pass to Dawson Baker with 120 seconds to go here in the third period. Stretch pass, too much on it for Sielek. No icing. Far side, it's quickly chipped along back to Civic. He's got Ford pressuring him, backhands it over far side. Jake Cox goes cross ice, throws one off the boards in front of the penalty boxes to Noah Robinson. Robinson shoved to the ground by Bione. Behind the net, Clay Keeley closes off a man as Ford chips it along to Sielek. 90 seconds to go here in Baton Rouge, Carolina. 5, Baton Rouge, nothing. Clay Keeley sends it along to Bione, dangerously playing it behind his own cage. He left it for Clay Keeley, who walks up the near side. A minute 10 to go here in the third. Carolina is going to pick up win number 29 here this season and bounce back after a 5-3 loss last night with only 6 of the roster guys here. Telstrom, far side, a shot, a save by Karpinski. Rebound attempt, and they score. It was a scramble in front after the initial save from Cody Karpinski. And it was Thomas McGuire The New York native getting his first goal here this season in his second game. He gets his sixth of his FPHL career. With 53 seconds to go here in the third, it's a 5-1 game. Faceoff is won by the Thunderbirds as they're back underway. And they dump it in. McGuire gets the goal. Matthias Telstrom gets an assist. And Austin Weber gets an assist as well. Carolina with another opportunity. Salaka's shot. That one's blocked by Kitsola. He gets it back, though, on the far side. Farmer settles it down to the blue line. Sends one in. It took a deflection from Pastuca. But Harney saw it the whole way and gloves it here at 23 seconds to go here in the third period. Nonetheless, though, Carolina is going to pick up the 3 points here tonight and improve to 29-10-1 this season and move up to 81 points here this year, while Baton Rouge is going to suffer their 26th loss here this season. After the 5-3 loss last night and the travel issues, Carolina with a good response here tonight. Flexing their muscles all evening and setting things up to take the rubber match coming up tomorrow evening at 8 p.m. Tucker Firth at the red line. MJ Graham sliding in. Firth will just hold it over in between the benches. 10 seconds to go here in Baton Rouge. Baker takes the loose puck. The only thing that didn't go the Thunderbirds' way tonight, that one goal that came with 53 seconds to go. That will do it here tonight from the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina responds with a emphatic 5-1 victory here over the Baton Rouge Zydeco this evening. Gus Ford a pair of points. Roman Kramer a pair of points. Yuri Pastuca a goal and assist here tonight. Jacob Schnapp, Clay Keeley, and Jan Salak and Dawson Baker finding the back of the net for Carolina here tonight. We have five different goal scorers. James Farmer, John Batita, and Tucker Firth pick up assists as well. Carolina wins it tonight by a score of 5-1. And Thunderbirds postgame begins on the other side of this timeout. Carolina victorious here in Baton Rouge. Thunderbirds postgame. After this, this is Thunderbirds hockey.
I want Huey to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. It takes care of us every day and when we go on adventures. We get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru, and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Huey.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
For over 85 years, Mustin and Crutchfield has been more than just a local market. We've been a proud part of North Carolina's heritage. When our founders started in 1938, they sourced meats from local farmers and groceries from small companies. Finding a way to stay competitive in this market has been a challenge through the years. Luckily, there are a lot of entrepreneurs, and now we have close to 50 local vendors that we feature. We're proud to partner with the Carolina Thunderbirds as a local sponsor, celebrating community values both on and off the ice. Mustin and Crutchfield, your hometown local grocer.
Carolina takes this one here tonight by a final score of 5-1 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco this evening here at the Raising Cane's River Center. Dawson Baker opened the scoring just about 10 minutes into the first period. Clay Keeley doubled the lead for Carolina at the 14-17 mark. Yuri Pastuca and Jan Salak combined for both goals in the second period as Carolina led 4-0 going into the third before Jacob Schnapp made it a 5-0 game at the 13-07 mark. Then with 53 seconds left, it was Thomas McGuire who was able to find the the back of the net on a mad scramble in front. And that is your final here this evening from the Raising Cane's River Center. Carolina wins 5-1 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco as they improve here this year to 29-10-1 and move up to 81 points here on the season. Baton Rouge drops to 9-26-4 as they sit put at 30 points here this year. We wrap up Thunderbirds postgame on the other side of this timeout. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
I want Hui to live a long, happy life. I give him supplements to take care of his joints. He's on preventatives to keep the fleas and ticks away. It's the same with my Subaru Outback. He takes care of us every day and when we go on adventures. We get our Outback serviced by the experts at Flo Subaru of Winston-Salem. I love my Subaru and I know it will live a long and happy life if I treat it right, just like Hui.
Hey there, Triad Thunderbirds fans. Introducing Tee It Up Indoors, your ultimate golfing destination in Greensboro. With our cutting-edge golf simulators, you can tee off on world-class courses, no matter the weather. We're not just a golf facility. We're your partner in having a fantastic time. From golf lessons to corporate events, we've got it all covered. Plus, we even host birthday parties. Tee It Up Indoors, where golf meets excitement. Contact us today and swing into action.
Riddle Tractor has been selling and servicing tractors, mowers, and more for over 43 years. We stock over 50,000 parts, and we service what we sell. Visit us at RiddleTractor.com. That's RiddleTractor.com, equipping those who get the job done.
Brendan Riley back with you for the final time this evening. Carolina wins by a final score of 5-1 over the Baton Rouge Zydeco. Dawson Baker sets a new career high in goals with 21. Jacob Schnapp sets a new career high as well as he got his 16th. Those two score the first and the last goal for Carolina here tonight. Yuri Pestuka, a pair of points as he now sits 1 point away from 300 in his FPHL career. Clay Keeley also got his second career FPHL goal here this evening. Carolina wins it here tonight by a final score of 5-1. Game 3 coming up tomorrow back here at the Raising Cane's River Center, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. local time. Pre-game coverage will start 30 minutes beforehand here on Thunderbirds TV and on WTOB. That'll do it for us here this evening from Baton Rouge. Carolina responds after the past two nights to come away with a 5-1 victory. For Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, back in our WTOB studios, I'm Brendan Riley saying so long from Baton Rouge. Come on back tomorrow for game number 3 coming up at 8 p.m. between Carolina and